Hello, everyone, and welcome.
Quick, bend over. Look at me. Now, eat your mattress.
I'm trying not to choke as I read that line. BSP created the universe. I'm scared to ask the context behind that, so I'm not gonna ask the context behind that. But I'm assuming there's context behind that. Dickinson Hand should have restreamed the guy. see Snow. Oh, you funny guy. You crazy guy. You funny. You fucking funny. No. Apparently YouTube just owes its entire existence to him. I'm just gonna assume he said something stupid and it's gonna be a clip at some point. I don't fucking know. What a thing to say. What an actual thing to say! The pre-stream was rough. I'm glad I really didn't watch any of it. I tuned in for like a grand total of 3 minutes. Because Tevin was restreaming. I get back home from shopping. Spoiler alert, I was out shopping. So when Karma comes in, you can tell him all about all the money I spent. All the money that he thinks he's entitled to that I spend. man. Yeah, we're doing a very short stream. It's not a long stream. I'm basically gonna watch him eat food and also take a look at the Neo figure that I got. Did you know that I ordered this Neo figure like quite literally, quite honestly, almost half a year ago plus? Kind of wild when you think about it. Did your reusable shopping bags get stolen? No, they did not. No. It was clothing shopping and whatnot. A little bit of grocery shopping, not a whole lot, honestly. I'm glad to hear that it's been some nonsense today. I don't know why Twitch thinks my bitrate is too low. Yeah, it can't be. It's like at 8K. And I'm not dropping frames, so it's just maybe not consistent. Whatever. Twitch, I'm doing everything I can, dude. Command. Literally doing everything I can. What's up, Krinox? Rookie numbers. It took my mail 14 months to get from Seattle Australia during the pandemic. Wow. Yeah, that is pretty rough. That actually is pretty rough. All right. Let us swap. I've been watching I was watching Shy for a little bit. I just realized that's like slightly out of, why is that like that? Like lightly out, I guess it is. It's like a little too big. Maybe. No, it's right. For some reason, it just doesn't catch the bottom of it. Okay, I'm not gonna complain about it. If I start complaining about it, then I'm never gonna hear the end of it.
Obviously. Bring yourselves unto me.
Look at this booba boat enjoyer. Yeah, we were doing booba boat nonsense for a little bit. Behind the scenes, obviously. Look at that. The emotes fall to the floor down there. What the fuck? I never noticed that. I guess it's because I'm technically in a, what is it, a world? and technically in a world. Here is... I've been watching Shy play video games. Been pretty good. He's currently playing, what is it? Nier Replicant. It looks like he's having fun. It looks like he's been having fun. I've been kind of hanging out and just, you know, chilling, relaxing.
Manolo seems like I gotta play just the Nier game 22 months.
At some point,
really
I have to.
It means a lot to me you have stuck around for so long. Thank
I'm
you so much,
I'm still missing out on the Nikkei goodness. You know, I am technically. I tried to play Nikkei for a little bit. I just couldn't get into it. Honestly, no offense to people who enjoy Limbus. I'm ready to uninstall Limbus. I tried playing it for a little bit. I don't see the appeal. I mean, there is appeal, but... Like, I truly just don't give a shit about this game.
But...
I feel so bad, because, like, it's not a bad game. It's just... I don't know. Not for me? Dingusty! God damn it, Chobla. God damn it, butt spot! They put the D in a sundress. Oh, yeah! Yeah, I don't know. It is what it is. But, I mean, if people like Limbus, it's fine. It's not a... It's a game. I don't really particularly enjoy it, so I kind of gave up on it. I was thinking about putting on and watching a little bit of Naked and Laughing's nonsense. I gotta tell you, I don't know. I actually do not know. To give you some perspective... This was one image that I captured just from like one of her deleted streams. And after that, I was just like, no, I don't think so. It's cool, Jessica. You can stick to your own. I don't want to know what's going on. I actually don't want to know what the fuck is going on. But apparently she, in that stream, she may or may not have slapped her cat. And that may or may not have been shown to Courtney, which is like a weird... She's kind of like a locale, but not really. She's in a weird position. But she runs like a little show where she has guests on her YouTube where it's generally cows and other weirdos and shit. And they come in and talk. And Cobra's been on there for quite some time. Cobra was invited... And it did not turn out good. Basically, people showed off Jessica's clips of her wanting to get a machete and her throwing a tantrum while he was in the call live. And that, yeah, there was a lot of, he was not happy with that. But God damn it. One of these days I'm going to figure out how to get, you know what? We're going to make it a different item one of these days. I gotta get an anvil. I know. I'm supposed to make an anvil. I just haven't gotten around to doing it yet. I did do a stupid style redeem. Where is it? Did I not activate it? I did not. Holy shit. I was like, wait a minute. I thought I had it. Apparently I did not. Words. My rewards, it's the channel points. I forgot to turn it on. Yeah, it was just cheese. It was just literally this. Because I don't know why. Freaking Bean was like, you need to put this cheese on here, and I was like, okay. So I put a piece of cheese and it just slapped my forehead, and I made it very, very large because, you know, who doesn't like cheese? You can redeem it once every minute. That way it's just nonstop, or it's not nonstop cheeses. Yeah, well, it is what it is. I didn't want to check out, naked and laughing thing. Oh yeah, that's right. The other thing, whenever I'm checking out stuff now, I forgot what the command is. Like, it's not R, maybe it's V. Yeah, V will hide the thing. Oh shit. It's V? Yeah, V will hide it. Maybe. No, it doesn't hide it. It hides it until I move. Well, I hover over it. I gotta do the setting for it. But basically, I have the ability now where if I need to watch DSP and I need to like super fast forward, I can now. Which is for any video. Also, speaking of videos, apparently we got a new Walnut Grove. Yeah, we need to listen to this.
I still haven't found Puff yet. I'm looking for him.
No, I don't wear diapers, to be quite honest with you. I actually free ball. Like, I pretty much like free ball, like, 95 to 100% of the time. Free ball. Like, I pretty much like free ball because it feels so nice. You know what I'm saying? I actually
free ball.
Like, I pretty much like free ball, like, 95 to 100% of the time. Free ball. Like, I pretty much like free ball because it feels so nice. No, I don't wear diapers, to be quite honest with you. I don't wear underwear unless it's cold outside. I only wear underwear, to be quite honest, you know, to keep my balls warm. Like, I don't wear underwear, therefore, I don't wear diapers. No, I don't wear diapers, dude.
Okay, you know what?
To be quite honest with you, I actually free ball. Like, I pretty much like free ball, like, 95 to 100% of the time.
He's just free balling, dude.
Free ball. Like, I pretty much like free ball because it feels so nice. You know what I'm saying? Like, I pretty much like free ball, like, 95 to 100% of the time. Free ball. Like, I pretty much like free ball because it feels so nice.
So nice. Ah, man, yeah, that was pretty good. You know what I found out today? Okay, this is gonna sound really, really ridiculous. A long, long time ago, okay, and people are gonna be like, "And how did you not know?" But look, about 4 years ago, I used to follow Made Mint.
Why not?
Back before the fucking channel got fucking eradicated, right? I didn't realize it, but I didn't know that she was actually Pomu the entire time. She became Pomu! And then she came back. Oh man, I miss the scuff streams. Back when her model was like, not as good. It was very simplified. These were the good days.
I mean, some serious honkers. A real set of badonkers. Packing some donbon honkeroos. Massive don honkum punkles.
Damn it.
Big old ton hunger
cooters. I know she still has this particular model. One day we'll get it back. Oh well. It is what it is. But I was kind of excited. Now I'm kind of like, whatever. I don't know. It's not like I don't like it. It's just, you know, now that I know, it's kind of weird. We'll never get the old ship back, by the way. Never. Yeah, she did return. She did technically return. I've waited all these years and then she finally returned. She went out for milk and to help her grandma and a sick cat. Which I have to assume all of those things are true. Because if I don't, then I have to realize she left so that way she could become an idol. And then she came back because, you know, things and reasons and shit. Okay. Let's check out DSP Gaming. What did he eat? I bet you it was something robust. Probably something flavorful. Holy crap. Oh shit, we're still doing this? What did he do today? Okay, hold up. What did he do today? I only watched like 4 minutes of this. We had a... Okay, so we had a really long podcast. What the fuck? It was like 2 hours. You've got to be kidding. No. This dude's trolling. Actually trolling. We had 2 hours. A pre-stream. Oh, you know what? That's why right there. He had 2 hours of pre-stream because he got juiced. He had $370. Wait, how much money does he have now?
of that.
Oh, shit, yo, he's fucking juiced up. Let's go. $625. Yo, trolls are punching air. Okay, what did he do here? He talked. Okay, after the pre-stream, he talked. What was this about? This better have been good. Was somebody like fucking tickling his balls or something? Oh my God.
Besides Elden Ring, everything's been going good. I don't want to ruin that now by interjecting a bunch of RPGs into the schedule. Okay, so we're not doing that.
Yes.
Okay. Ben Rogers said Dave the Diver is an indie game coming to PS Plus soon. If it's right under a night stream. Okay.
Oh, he right. just heard
Let's
of
now
Dave
take
the
a look
Diver.
At May.
All Wait, right? what? No. No. This is all the schedule. Oh, no. This is all the schedule. This is the thing that he said he was going to do. Oh, no. I'm actually kind of disappointed right now. God damn it. I wasn't expecting this. Fucking A. This dude really knows how to, like, kill time, man. So he did a schedule site. You know what? That's why it was. Okay. All right. All right. So I saw Dingus post up something. He posted up a big list. And I was assuming this, like, oh, this is the predictions of whatever he's going to do. This is actually what he's going to do. For those of you who don't know, in the super secret Discord. Here it is. I thought this was like, you know, like a thing, right? But this is actually what he's going to play. Or at least what he's interested in. Grounded? He's not going to play Grounded. That's not happening. Harold Halibut. Halibut. Really? What? A Yuden Chronicle. Didn't he say he was going to play this? This is on the list for his own autistic reference, but this is 100% a skip. Interested in due to connection of Suikoden. Another Crab's Treasure. Crab Souls-like. No, this guy's trolling. We're not doing any of this. This is trolling. Get out of here, trolls. Yeah, this is random games. What the fuck? All right, we have April Focus is continuing Elden Ring, obviously. So we're not going to do any of this. Hellblade 2. What the fuck? System Shock Remake? System Shock Remake. All right. Paper Mario Thousand Year Door. He can't skip this. Multiverses? Wow, we're bringing multiverse? No way. I cannot believe that. That's insanity. Because that didn't do well the first time. For him to bring that back again, man. Nah, come on. Did he ever do the Grinch game? He did. He played it, I believe. I don't know if he completed it, but he definitely did play it. Luigi's Mansion. I feel like he might, but I don't think he's going to do Super Monkey Ball. I feel like this is like a we're doing it just to see if anybody's going to care. But I feel like we're going to do this. Agatha Christie's ABC What? Agatha Christie's ABC Murders. The fuck is this? Am I gonna find a fucking thing on this? Okay. There's a book. What? Oh, full game walkthrough, no commentary. Five. Wait. This is a game from multiple years ago? What? This can't. No. Yeah, this has to be a new game. Yeah, hold up. No, there has to be a new game about this. Fuck? Is this the same game?
Agatha Christie, the ABC
Murders.
Puzzle sequence when they are interacted with. Early examples include a puzzle box which must be opened to gain the contents inside, or comparing letters sent from a potential perpetrator. Others will see you having to be vigilant as a code to open a secret compartment or a padlock.
I understand it's a switch port, and it's also I don't know if that's on the Switch too. I don't know, because that's 5 years ago. So it means this game's been out. And it's on the PC? Hey, can I get this on Steam? Is this on Steam right now? Get out of here. I was looking at spell disc. Yeah. It's on P2016. Oh, come on. No way. No the fuck. What the fuck? Get out of here. You were kidding me. This game has like been here forever. What are we doing? This guy's trolling. Actually trolling. That can't be real. That's made up. I stay with Aang like Stitch stay with Lilo. Oh my god, thank you, Tevin.
Almighty underscore Tevin just resubscribed for 22 months. Well, guys, we got a year-long badass.
Is he actually playing this game?
Thank you for sticking by me. I stay with Aang like Stitch stay with Lilo.
There's no way in July he's gonna make a playthrough of a game that's almost an actual factual decade year old. That's some bullshit. I don't care if it's free. That's whatever. Black Myth Wukong, I feel like he should play this. Stalker 2? Why? That's a troll right there. He didn't like the Stalker game he did play. And Space Marine 2! And then we got Terminator Survivors. What? Yo, this dog is... This guy's insane! Actually insane! I cannot believe this. This guy is just making shit up. No, he is definitely not playing Space Marine. Well, okay. I don't see him playing Space Marine, and I can't imagine him playing Stalker. I could see him being tricked into Stalker, but like, that's some wild buffoonery right there. What else did he do? Let me see. Sorry. I didn't want to cough in y'all's face. What did we do? Played Helldivers. How long did we play Helldivers for? Okay, he played Helldivers for roughly an hour? It started around, 3:46. Yeah, we got an hour of Helldivers played. So that was cool. All right, pretty cool. Hey, food segment. Oh my God, fucking white noise segment too. Where is it? This is gonna be the bonus, look at this. We can speed this up to light speed. We can like super speed this. I'm at like fucking 16 times speed. You guys can't tell because nothing's going on. It's literally just a chair. But what if it was like something moving? Oh my gosh.
No. And you have like this big family of
Jesus. All right, he came back.
Okay, I got my Korean barbecue food to show you.
Korean barbecue? What? Oh, and he did take out Korean barbecue too. Oh, that's sad. I literally just went to a Korean barcue place for my sister's birthday. That shit was pretty good too. That was like, man, I gotta tell you, that was the definition of yum yum. Eat. Korean barbecue.
And
I thought Anne was gonna skip the birthday event and take a nap. I actually did take a nap. So I've already skipped almost 6 hours of content. I didn't even see the first part, and I don't care to listen to the pre-stream.
Guys, I've never done this ever before.
All right, Korean barbecue.
To do, because the original, first time thing for the show anyway. This is the third time I've eaten at the restaurant.
Okay. We'll do 4 times speed. We'll do 5 times speed. We gotta get past the shout outs.
That
was great because now I'll never have to sit and suffer. I can suffer much, much quicker. Oh, wait, no, I saw a really good frame on that.
Okay, this is Korean barbecue. Thank you, No Tengo Dinero, for 2 months as a member.
Ha 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 ha! That's pretty good. Oh, that's really good. I'm gonna give that in 1080p.
Very exciting stuff. Good job there.
Yeah, that's a keeper. He's currently booting up Street Fighter 6 instead of Derek's dumbass quiz he made with Kahoon, and is banning anyone that says he's being mean for ignoring it. Says Derek sent it in late. He sent it in 2 days before. He didn't even look at the email and ignored Derek's attempt to send instructions. No. Oh shit, are you serious? Yo. That's actually kind of funny. That's actually hilarious. And well deserved.
The champ is here.
No, the champ is not here.
Let me repeat that again.
The champ is not here. The champ got sent to the band world.
The champ is here.
Yeah, meme template screenshot. Look, come on.
So this is a Korean.
Oh, that's sad. Oh no, bros, what are we eating? Oh, we were eating good. So you ain't eating good? No. We got some just like some rice noodles and shit and some rice and presumably chicken. I can't tell if that's cauliflower or mushrooms either. Fucking A. We didn't even get the good stuff. Fucking A. Yeah, brother.
Barbecue platter.
Okay.
Obviously, you got white rice and spicy barbecue pork.
Oh, that's pork. All right.
Okay. Then we've got seasoned golden potatoes.
Seasoned golden potatoes? What? What is this video you wanted me to check out? What is this? $50 for no ending, you know what? $50 for no ending. Hey, it's I'm 41. Thank you. Let's listen to this. I just realized, what do you think DSP would do if he saw this? Do you think he would actually play this in his pre-stream? You know what? I'm going to take a bet. What's the over under DSP attempts to use this as a pre-stream song? Yeah, I think so. I think he's trying to own the trolls from this. I can see it happening. Oh my god. I'll watch it all the way through, because I got the point redeemed for it. I don't feel good about it. Yeah, okay, it definitely would get copyrighted. Because this is the same guy who did Baboon BBC. Where is it? He did this song. Where is it? The same guy.
I'll be that monkey. I'll be that monkey. Yup. With the BBC. Enjoy it.
I don't think DSP is going to use a song with this being the other song he's done. funny part is, it's not even a fucking baboon. It's a mandrill. I mean, it does hate on LTG, but I don't know. I'm gonna stop it because I know nonsense. I kind of want to play this out, but there's no way. I'll listen to the rest of Baboon BBC though. He hides from the snorts. God damn it. Why do you exist? You suck so hard. Please burn in hell. And it does sound like a Breezestream song. You know. It would be so good, though. No, this song would be way too good for the Breezestream. It's like way too, you know. Look at this. Bro, this would be way too much production. We can't be having that now. You don't know what happened, fuck you. You don't know what happened, fuck you. You don't know what happened. $50, no ending. You don't know what happened. Yeah, this is way too robust. He can't have something like this.
$50 and you don't
it's really good. It's really good what they were able to do with BSP singing and adding it with a guitar. This is very well done. I will say this. Pretty cool, big ups. I hope he doesn't use this as a pre-stream song, but I will say unironically, if this somehow or another ended up as a pre-stream song, it would be the best pre-stream song he would have, period. I think that actually beats out Mole Man, and I actually unironically enjoy Mole Man. Fuck. You know what? It's pretty good. But this is the other song.
Bring your fucking mom to the zoo. I'll be a monkey in your room, swinging like a big ass baboon. I'ma come bubblegum. I'ma tell you when I cry. Beating me with a bottle of wine. Put a Tarzan outfit on. Swag, baby, woo! I'm the winner here. There is some room on my image. I never gas. But I'm trash though. Appreciate the five.
I like him. I'ma see how long I'm banned for.
Are you gotta be? Play that role play. Hopping and dipping.
Pictures.
Retard. Talent. Freedom. I'ma come bubblegum. I don't wanna have to play the same niggas.
Baboon BBC.
Baboon BBC.
Baboon BBC.
Baboon BBC.
Baboon BBC.
Baboon BBC. Baboon BBC. Baboon BBC. Oh my god! You sorry ass fat nigga!
I'm like frustrated right now that the FGC makes me money. I don't understand that.
Do y'all say what the fuck I'm talking about?
Come up with your own fucking
language. He's just having a good time.
Trash life. Slaving. Know. One skill, three rounds. Whack ass. Footsies. Moron. Wake up. Not real. Or with lag.
Blacklist.
Play me again.
What the fuck do you want?
You gotta pay me to play me, you dumbass niggas. I cut on chaos. Niggas stream suck me. I cut on attacking. Niggas stream suck me. I cut on Street Fighter.
Nigga stream snipe me. I cut on Soul Calibur. Nigga stream snipe me. I cut on MK11. Every time I cut on the game, I cut on Chaos. Nigga stream snipe me. I cut on Tekken. Nigga stream snipe me. I cut on Street Fighter. Nigga stream snipe me. I cut on Soul Calibur. Nigga stream snipe me. I cut on MK11.
On any game, they're all there. Stream snipe.
Baboon BDC. Baboon BDC. Baboon BDC. Baboon BDC. Baboon BDC. Baboon BDC. Baboon BDC.
This, you know what? This is always going to be my favorite song out of all the songs that Sum 41 has. Or Sum 41. I'm 41. Sorry. I was thinking. God damn it, Debater. Shut up with the remix. He's the piss bottle was okay. Is it deep was so-so. I have not listened to this one. DSP versus LTG the blast. When I say bum, oh shit, yo, this is making okay. I shouldn't go on too much, but he did have a really bad segment because he had like Texas speech and people were trying to talk about how, you know, back in the day and the stories he used to tell, and it involves showers and poop, if you will. I'm not going to explain any further. You have to go ahead and look at the stories. But yeah, there were basically some stories that he used to tell. He's kind of embarrassed about it. Somebody did a Texas speech payment for it. And when I say bum was constantly being spammed by him as it was saying it, so he could say over it and he could cut off the TTS because he couldn't cut it off fast enough. But yeah, did not have a good time with that one. Yeah, that one's not a really great story to know about. But big ups. What was I looking at? Oh yeah, DSP eating food. Eat food. I gotta tell you, man, this Korean place he's ordering from, this, I swear to God, this better have been less than fucking 10 bucks, because this is kind of pathetic. You are basically paying for the pork and like maybe the noodles, because the rice is worthless and the potatoes are worthless. You didn't even get half a potato. You got like a third of a potato. Bruh, come on. This is like some white people shit. Some fucking seasoned potatoes. Really? Get out of here.
This kind of unique rice noodle. I don't even know what it is, but it's seasoned, interestingly.
This rice noodle, which I don't even know what it is, but it's seasoned, interestingly. What?
Pork. Okay. Then we've got seasoned golden potatoes. This kind of unique rice noodle. I don't even know what it is, but it's seasoned, interestingly.
This unique rice noodle that is seasoned, interestingly. Bro, it's rice noodles. I got like 5 packs of rice noodles in my cupboard right now. They're just rice noodles. No, lo mein are, they're thicker noodles. Rice noodles are kind of like see-through. And it's probably like flavored with soy and whatnot. And it looks like it has carrots and broccoli in it. That's so like basic, man.
And then we've got macaroni salad down there.
That's macaroni salad? What? Oh no, are you serious? Bro, how much they charge you for this? This is not Korean people food. This is sad. Yo, what the fuck?
Okay. So this comes as like a deal.
It's basically
a
white
combo that you
can mac
get.
And cheese.
All right. I've also had their bibimbap and their meal combo that you can get. All right. I've also had their bibimbap, a meal combo that you can get. All right. I've also had their bibimbap.
Okay, I may actually want him to say the word bibimbap.
a meal combo that you can get. All right. I've also had their bibimbap. Can get. All right. I've also had their bibimbap.
I want to isolate that. Hold up. Give me 2 seconds. Bibimbap. What a random, like, okay, if it's an actual thing, it's just funny when he says it, because, like, you can't imagine it being an actual thing. You just think it's like a made-up thing, right? Right? Where is it?
Their bibimbap. Bibimbap.
Bibimbap.
Bibimbap.
Big ups, bibimbap. All right, we'll put a little fade in here, or else it'll pop. So you gotta fade, no, not fade out, you gotta fade in. You gotta delete this and then fade that out. That's the only way, like, when you have to make sound clips of him, because he has that, like, thing.
Bibimbap.
It is not.
Bibimbap.
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 It is.
Bibimbap.
Desire.
Bibimbap.
Sarah, would you like some?
Bibimbap.
I have some.
Bibimbap.
In the fridge.
Bibimbap.
Is ready to eat.
Bibimbap.
Bibimbap. Bibimbap. Hello, Sarah. Oh, wait. Oh, shit. No, last night. Okay, okay. Sarah was in a dream, but last night I woke up and I thought I saw you were streaming. Were you streaming last night? Hold up. I gotta see. Was Sarah streaming and then I didn't realize it, but I saw it? It could have been a dream. It actually could have been a dream. Oh wait, that's not the other command. I keep forgetting there's like 2 commands. It's this one. Yeah, okay, you were playing Diablo 3. Okay.
There you yes. go. I'm learning cheese.
She's learning I'm cheese, dude.
Learning cheese.
Laughing.
I guess I was learning. Sleeping and then somebody maybe somebody raided
learning.
You.
I'm learning cheese.
And then I like saw it. As I woke up, you were delirious after I sent you to her. That's right, probably what it was. Wait, yeah, I guess I was watching Dingus. I kind of forgot about that. Oh, we gotta save this. This is gonna be saved as Bibim ESP Bibim Bibim Bop ESP Bibim Bop. I don't fucking know. ESP Bibim Bop MP3. All right. There you go. If we ever need Bibimbap, we have it on deck now. I just have to add it to a thing. But hello, Sarah. You're at the perfect time. I'm trying to figure out what he ate. He says this is Korean barbecue, but like, I think he got scammed. Cause like, there's only one thing on here that's barbecue, and I would not say that this is worth whatever the fucking entry price was for all of this. But then again, like, I'm also somebody who just recently had Korean barbecue, and it was very robust and expensive, but it was like one of those Korean barbecue joints where you grill it in front of you. Oh man, I was going to town, fucking ordering all sorts of nonsense. All sorts of fucking nonsense. We had three grill changes too. That was good.
And their bibimbap was very tasty and had a bunch of stuff in it. I didn't even know what it was.
Bibimbap.
But it tasted great. Okay, so this is a combo from this restaurant, and it's unique. I mean, it's so cool. These things you wouldn't really have. This noodles. I don't even know what kind of noodles they are.
You know? No, you but just said delicious. They were rice noodles. Oh. Ooh. The cat get hungry? Cause it looks like she was taking a little bit of bite off the top. That's kind of unfortunate.
So let me go ahead. I'm going to try these various different things. There's so much condensation in the box that it's like soaking wet. Maybe I can soak up some of that condensation with this paper towel so it doesn't spill all over the place.
Okay, let's just get to the eating segment.
Holy crap.
Oh, wait. Oh, I saw that.
Where did I put the...
Oh, no. It hits you so fast, man.
The fork. Oh, shit. Well, here it is. It fell. Okay. The start.
The tongue is pretty good. Yeah, it is.
I'm gonna try the...
because like the thing you would do, like the thing I would do when I do the ordering and whatnot, Pork Belly gets everything nice and it's quick and it gets everything nice and greasy. And then you can slap stuff on top of that as well. It really, really works. Oh my gosh, Bean!
Sweet Bean, happy birthday! It's not my birthday. For 8 months.
You're late to the party.
It really means a lot to me you have stuck around for so long. Thank you so much, Baka.
Hello,
happy
Bean.
Happy birthday, and why Kirby happy?
Spicy barbecue pork up
I
here.
I wanted to see. You know what? This is literally the only segment that I was looking forward to out of DSP's entire birthday. Just him eating. Could you imagine that? DSP that. Eating segment.
Look at that Whoa. Piece.
Dripping.
Looks good.
Ah, yes.
Devour. Devour.
Yum, yum.
Very tender.
Very tender. It's sweet and savory and a little bit of spice.
It has both a savoriness and a sweetness to it. But now the Favorite spice cheese. It's ooh. Now the spice it's after the fact. And it's like I said, it's like a sweet
Yeah, I added
coating,
the cheese and I put a little slap
with
sound
a
to
little
it.
Of a savory saltiness.
I but wanted man, to make a throwable after, like a bite thing, but I gotta change get. It to something else. I feel like stinky cheese too is a throwable as well, but you know, it is what it is. I looked up some other stuff that they were giving away as well. There's a lot of people
it's very
that
tender
did stuff
and juicy.
Under that tag.
It's not dried out or overcooked. It's cooked just
Tender
right.
Tender and juicy.
The potato. Let's eat a potato.
Whoa, buddy.
It's potato.
It's literally a potato.
That's a 10.
Okay, thank you for the chug. Trying not to die. I promise I'm trying not to die, but I feel like I'm dying. I mean, you know, we're all dying, but you know what I mean. It's dude, it's literally a potato.
In something, I don't know what, but you can see it's completely saturated with like a you know sauce, and it looks like it's sucked into the potato like a sponge.
I kind of wonder whether or not he's actually cooked food before. DSP, have you ever cooked a potato before? I'm kind of curious. How does one cook a potato?
Okay,
has he ever cut
potato.
A potato? Maybe peeled a potato? I don't think he's ever, you know,
melted
what
your mouth completely.
The only potato this dude's ever seen is Cat, which is kind of sad. I shouldn't say that about Cat, but like, come on, man.
Completely.
That's the kind of face I make when I eat a potato. Yep. It's potato. It's a starch.
I can't even put my finger on what they marinated it in.
Okay.
It's good though.
All right, cool. Let's eat some of the
try
rice
some of the
noodles.
Glass noodles.
The what?
It's good though. Let's try some of the glass noodles.
The glass noodles.
Shoudao.
Ha ha ha!
Shoudao!
I gotta hear that one more time.
Say it right.
It's good though. Let's try some of the glass noodles.
Glass.
I think they call them glass noodles because they're translucent, right? I think that's what it is.
Glass noodles. Do they really? I have never heard it ever called glass noodles. Ever. I mean, it's probably called this, but it's such a weird thing to call it. Yeah, it's like it literally is called glass noodles. No way. Okay, what the fuck? They're just made of rice. Well, I mean, they can be made of rice. They can be made of other things too, but generally it's rice. Okay, big ups glass noodles. They are japchae noodles. I don't know what those are, but it sounds pretty good. It's just a little weird. I hate him saying it because it sounds extra foreign when DSP like comes up with a word to say and it doesn't sound real, you know?
There's some carrots mixed in with the noodles. See that?
He's
a carrot.
I eat these kind of noodles. They're usually made of rice, but you can make them out of anything, really. Anything that's starchy. Mm. And it's just kind of wild for him to, like, I don't know.
Sweet. The noodles are very sweet.
You know.
This you get a little bit weird. Of salt, but it's actually very sweet. You wouldn't expect a noodle to be sweet like that. But it's good. There's actually a piece of broccoli. A tiny piece of broccoli.
Wow. That's the first time I've ever seen him eat something green. Wait, no, what? That's a lie. I think I've seen him eat a salad before.
Now, they give you macaroni salad.
Why?
This restaurant happens to serve both cuisines of Korea and Hawaii.
Oh.
That might sound weird to you, but out here, this is the landing spot, the Pacific Northwest Airport. It's SeaTac Airport. And all these Asian cultures have fused together out here. So I'm not surprised that they do more than one kind of food. So I don't know if this is more Hawaiian style or Korean style macaroni salad. Okay. But they also have like spam musubi and other things there. So anyway, here's some of the macaroni salad.
Wow. Yeah, it's like it is like an Asian fusion dance.
The only thing I'll say, it's very creamy but very bland. It doesn't have any tang to it. Like a lot of macaroni salads are like a vinegar. Bland.
Yeah, because they use
this
mustard
is very
and
just
shit.
Bland macaroni salad. So out of a whole plate, actually the macaroni salad is probably the worst thing.
Don't say
let's
the
try
rice is anything.
The rice,
than...
although it's probably just basic rice, right? There's nothing special about it.
It's literally white rice, dude.
Yeah, just plain white rice.
No shit.
You know what that tastes like.
Do we? Can you explain it?
Okay.
Can you explain the starchiness?
This meat is super good.
Oh,
I really like this
God.
Spicy pork. Mmm.
I'm already frustrated. I'm literally already frustrated at this. I don't know how to feel about any
so much of
this.
Oh my God.
Look at this. He looks at the data
so
when
much
it
of
happens.
It. Oh my God.
Holy shit, you seeing this? He doesn't even look at the camera. He literally doesn't even look at the camera. He looks at the data for confirmation. Hey, is the camera currently picking up what I'm currently picking up right now? I'm gonna screenshot that. That's pretty good. You can insert, you know what? You could Photoshop anything into that. Now that I think about it. Dude, wait, Demeter. Demeter, where's Saru? Saru, Demeter, you literally could put anything on this fork. You literally could put anything in this fork. And he would be given this look. Think about it.
I don't know how I'm going to fit that in my mouth.
It's how like am I going to fit pig. This meat in my mouth?
In one piece of meat.
You could chew
Holy
it.
Moly.
You could.
The thing is with this pork, it's delicious and tender and juicy, but I gotta be careful. If I eat too fast, it's gonna build up too much spice too fast and burn my mouth.
What?
I don't wanna do that.
What do you mean by that, Bill? I gotta slow down. Eat too fast. It's gonna get too spicy real quick. Oh, man. It's a spice meter. Thank you, gamers. Yeah, I was thinking
about
that.
Like this
dude has like a little spice meter, and it goes up.
Piece, you know? And it all complements each other.
What?
Everything here tastes good with
this
the other
so
things.
This is so ridiculous. I cannot believe it. This is what I was looking forward to. Wait, did he eat the fucking cake? No, he didn't have cake. He was supposed to have brownies. Somebody told me he was supposed to have brownies. And I was supposed to get excited for that. And I don't know. Did he already eat it? I need to know. Chat, spoil me.
Lock on.
So sweet. I can't put my finger on what this is. Potato seasoning. I don't know. I honestly can't tell.
No pain cake. After Street Fighter?
It's got a little bit of a different flavor.
Okay, brownies are coming.
Hanging it.
So we didn't even get the brownies.
But I have no idea what they marinate
that in. That's the thing I'm looking forward to.
Well, guys, we got a year long
battle. I've never had a poo-poo platter.
Thank you for sticking with me.
No, I'm not really a fan of mix. No, I've never had a poo-poo platter. No, I'm not really a fan of
poo-poo platter.
The mixing. I like tasting the things separate because they all have their own flavors that you want to enjoy. You mix them together, then you're not really getting each individual flavor, right?
No, you actually eat them together.
That's a lot of noodles.
That's the point of having them together. You eat them together. You do not eat the rice. Well, I mean, you can eat the rice by itself, but that's so weird. Usually you eat the pork with the rice.
Sweetness with noodle?
Oh my god.
It's not something that's common or you would expect. You always expect noodles will be like savory or cheesy.
I want to eat the rice alone.
It's very unique.
Oh, is that the Yummy Kitchen is where he ordered it from?
Welcome back, Derek.
Oh, Derek.
How different is it from Chinese food? Well, think about it.
Wait, he didn't get cucked yet.
They don't have anything like this. They don't have any of these sides. I don't think I've ever seen a potato in Chinese food once. Right? I mean, yes, Chinese people have noodles, but usually it's in some kind of like a sauce or like think about it. You get Chinese lo mein. It's always in a stir fry sauce. This, the glass noodle has absorbed the flavor of whatever it is they cooked in it. It's not wet. It's actually like a drier noodle, but it's full of flavor, right?
What?
It's so different from a Chinese presentation,
What's
you know?
Mean?
It really does feel completely different.
What a... Okay.
All right. And by the way, I will shout out contributions after I've eaten a bit here, just so you know, because I saw a tip
very
come in.
Very gassy, too. After I've eaten a bit, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, they have potatoes in stew. Like, I'm trying to think, it's like, they
it's
have
very
it
good,
in Chinese cuisine,
a lot of
but
meat.
It's like... I don't know. It's a...
I don't think I'll be eating this
much
of the pork.
It's their starch.
It's a ton
of
meat.
Rice is their starch, too, you know? Yeah, he got a lot of money. $600. Apparently, he was like almost at 400 when he ended the pre-stream. And then he like did a thing. You know what? I just realized something. Did he even have any drinks? Was he supposed to drink during this whole thing? Oh, he did. Okay, wait. Some 253. I gotta, okay. No, I gotta check this out. We're gonna use another thing. He didn't. I was scrolling around. I didn't see any shots.
Action, and you can't react.
Get out of here. He's complaining. Where did he have this? Did he come back? Yeah, he did. What did he come back with? My lord, please. Why? Why does. Fucking YouTube hates Firefox right now. They really, really hate Firefox. Okay, here it is. I just want to see what the drink was.
Okay, babe. Pre-stream all stream. It can't be a
Really? How much ice is in there? What the fuck? Oh, that straw is up vertical. There's so much ice in that. He had a mojito and a Long Island. Oh, come on, man. That's literally nothing. He's drinking liquid rocks right now.
See the drink. The ring light doesn't really let you see the drink, but it's mojito, a mojito mix in a party cup with a bunch of ice.
Oh, he's out of breath.
Okay.
I just realized he was out of breath saying that. Get out of here for a second.
A bunch of ice.
Listen to that. I want to listen to that. Just put it in 480p. 720? 480. only need to listen to it. God, please! Let me fucking enjoy DSP out of breath, man. Okay, listen to this.
A mojito mix in a party cup with a bunch of ice. Okay. We're gonna get started. Actually, I got another tip during the break.
Yeah, he was kind of out of breath doing that. That was kind of wild. All right, well, whatever.
I wonder how it's made. It's got to be stir-fried, right? This meat, you would think so.
Stir-fried at a Korean barbecue instead of barbecuing the meat. Really? It wouldn't make much for a barbecue then if it was stir-fried. Did he even realize what he said? Anything noteworthy?
It's very, very
flavorful. I haven't watched this.
And very full of moisture. But it's also fatty meat, to forewarn you.
I just got to the food segment.
Barbecue,
I didn't watch the pre-stream or nothing.
So you could tell there's fat, a lot of fat in this pork.
Like,
probably not something you would want to eat all the time, right?
I will say this. I really refuse to watch the fucking birthday event because before I left today, I saw that we didn't have any decorations. We didn't do anything. And then skimming through all of this, we had a 2 hour pre-stream. We talked about video games we could play. We brought in a mojito, played Helldivers for an hour, and then ate some food. Then I don't know what. No, he's watched his own YouTube videos for a bit, and now he's playing Street Fighter, which presumably there's nothing left except the birthday fucking thing, the birthday bricks, which is actually kind of concerning because I thought we were supposed to have a Derek segment, but apparently Derek is getting felted. Again, a second time. So I don't know. Yeah, I missed the Sad Boy balloons too. I thought we were gonna get some of those, but we didn't even get any of those. No, we literally just watched Free Ball. We literally just Sonaquan, you're gonna get a refund on that. We literally opened with Free Ball. That we watched right in the beginning. You missed it. Yeah, you're late. You're literally late. That was like the opener. If you want to drop a different video that you want me to watch, that's fine. If not, I'll refund you. Either way. But we literally watched Free Ball. You know what? We can watch Free Ball again.
But
just for you, we can watch Free Ball again if you want.
I still haven't found Puff yet. I'm looking for him.
No, I don't wear diapers, to be quite honest with you.
Yeah, you can request another one, too.
Like, I pretty much like Free Ball like 95 to 100% of the time. Free Ball. Like, I pretty much like Free Ball because it feels so nice.
So nice.
I actually Free Ball. Like, I pretty much like Free Ball like 95 to 100% of the time. Free Ball. Like, I pretty much like Free Ball
that face. Because it that feels face so gets nice. Me every time.
No, I don't wear diapers, to be quite honest with you. I don't wear underwear unless it's cold outside. I only wear underwear, to be quite honest, you know, to keep my balls warm. Like, I don't wear underwear, therefore, I don't wear diapers. No, I don't wear diapers, dude.
He's okay, not a diaper man.
To be quite honest with you, I actually free ball. Free ball.
What's your favorite?
Much like Free Ball.
Which one is that one?
95 to 100% of the time.
Hickory Dickory Dog.
Free Ball. Like, I pretty much like Free Ball.
I actually haven't watched this.
So nice.
It's age restricted.
You know, I actually Free Ball.
Hold
like,
up.
I pretty much like
Hold
Free
up.
Ball. Like, 95 to 100% of the time. Free Ball. Like, I pretty much like Free Ball because it feels so nice.
Okay, we don't have any penises. Alright, it is age restricted, but I am gonna watch it nonetheless.
Eventually I said, fuck you, jolly green bean, 6 foot tall, having fucking shit on the end of your nose, fucking looking like a jolly green giant.
Your pussy
fucking
smells
bitch.
Like Wendy's.
What?
That line. To this day. Okay. Fellas. Never. Ever tell your lady. Her pussy smells like anything. Just don't. Just literally never, ever, ever say this. Never. Just don't. What the fuck?
What is up, fellow YouTubers? It's your favorite sexy goth bad boy, the legendary King Cobra, back in another video. They say he's sexist, he's racist, he's this and that. It is what it is, YouTube. It's the fucking truth. And that's the thing of it. I laugh my ass off at that shit, you know? I laugh at it. I mean, Christ, you're supposed to laugh at it, otherwise you're a sexist. Dude, here's something to think about. Hickory, dickory, dog, dog. These fucking trolls can suck my cock. Cobra's clock struck 12. 12. Now it's only one.
One.
You know? And fuck these trolls up and they're fucking done. And don't get me started on a fucking little Bo Peep and her fucking sheep. Fuck these trolls, talk is cheap. Fuck little Bo Peep, fuck the trolls, you know? And let me ask you this. If you identify as a goddamn troll, how does the fuck does that work, dude? Like, it's fucking ridiculous, you know? And don't get me started on hickory dickory dog, dog. These fucking trolls can suck my cock. Cobra's clock struck 12.
12.
Now it's only one.
One.
You know? And fuck these trolls up and they're fucking done. Hickory
dickory
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 dickory dog,
dog.
Cock, suck my cock, dude. Suck my cock.
All right, there you go. You got a twofer. You literally got a twofer. That's like the best you could ever ask for. But big ups the redeem. We do appreciate it very much, very bigly. Did I see the Cobra interview? If it's the Cobra interview with Clint, yes. If it's the Cobra interview as in Cobra being a guest on Courtney's show recently, yes, I've seen both of those. So yes, I've seen both of those, but big ups. And yeah, look, my whole thing, Nurgle, to answer your question, in general, you do not comment. Look, if you're gonna comment on your partner, usually smell is not going to be a thing unless they're into that, and it's just don't. That's a no. Most people are, usually you're going to go with smells is either going to be something is I'm going to eat or something that is not good to witness, kind of thing. It's one of those situations. So in general, no. But you don't ever tell your girl that she smells like Wendy's. That is wild.
But.
That's literally wild. Mm. Yeah, definitely not a fucking Wendy's. That's so crass, man. It's out of stock. That's Sarah, you can just.
What did my wife get? She got.
You can take a look at it.
A variation of bulgogi. So bulgogi is Korean barbecue meat, like beef.
Bulgogi is pretty good.
But the one she got, get this. I forget what they call it. They cook that bulgogi in eggs.
Yeah.
So it's like having almost like a fried egg.
Yeah.
Scrambled combined with the beef.
Yeah.
And it comes in these like slats. I don't know how to explain it. It's like a stack of almost like egg and meat pancakes. And you eat them, you dip them in a sauce. They come with a sauce. You dip it in, you eat it. It's crazy different from anything.
I don't think slats is the word he should use, because if you're cooking like a bunch of it in egg, like that's its own thing because the egg is binding it all together. Slats is not the word I would have used.
I don't even know where they came up with that idea. But it's super good. So that's what my wife got. And the rest of the platter is the same. It's just the meat is different.
What the fuck?
Potato?
Okay. I will say this. I have not actually seen the King of the Ring finals. I'm assuming this was a submission.
Likes 1,011 has redeemed the following TTS message.
This looks
slats,
pretty solid.
He meant sleep. Get sleep.
Oh, no, shut up. Shut up.
Well, I'd do it for the party. Gotta keep it wild. Hey, Gail, drop the beat. See you, Philip. spent 140 hours.
Oh my god, the rock fire.
Are we doing this?
You know there are very few of these left out there in the wild? I can tell which one it is. Oh, you know what? I actually know which one this is.
Yeah, man.
I actually know which one this is.
A druid who can pin you down and do you right. Well, come on,
there are only a few of these left out there.
What it feel like. I come up behind you and I ask you what you're sipping on.
Smells robust.
And you tell me that it's gin that was purchased with donations. Don't look in my eyes, I'm taking you from behind. It's the one time bestiality ain't a crime. You'll be getting on the ground, I hear your snorting sound. Do it doggy style, cause you need tummy time. You wanna make love to this bird.
She still has an arm! Okay, this is how you can tell where it is. If you know what she is currently wearing, you'll know where this is, because there's only one location that has this. I will say this, but it is this one. I know where this is. I actually know where this is.
Just reorganize the party, that's a thing that you know how to do.
How to do. Right?
Boy, don't keep me waiting when I really wanna mount you.
Giddy up.
Send Minsk to the campsite, cause you are my only boo.
Yes, bro. Stay away from hamsters.
Don't look in my eyes, I'm taking you from behind.
It's Sung Minsk.
I can't take it no more, Philip, I'm coming for you. You've been teasing me with that ass. God, what a fat ass. Then we'll get burgers if that's cool with you.
You wanna
make love to this bed.
DJ Fuck Fridge.
I'm what you want.
She's what you want.
I'm what you need.
She's what you need.
I keep things chill. But I'm a freak sexually, mentally, physically, emotionally. I can take your biggest loads of practice on your grocery.
Oh.
I know you gave your love to the druid, but your boy can share it. That's right, he's poly, even when you don't turn into a fairy. Put me in the woods, you're the pig, I got my sense.
God.
Oh, you better swim open till you see my little wife. I make your love to a fridge and a bear who's in wild shape. I don't even wanna know what kind of freaky child we make. We are side dumb, we'll spackle you. Call me William Perry, cause I'll join the bears and tackle you.
No, you can't give me a kiss. If we keep fucking like this, I'll reach around though if you need it to be shooting. Consummating with the bear, keep it up, feeling, I swear. I'ma give it to you non-stop, and I don't care. Jade's watching, watching, watching. He has questions. Oh, in the woods with a bear, the safe word is puer. You wanna make love to this bear?
Hey,
to this bear, to this bear,
to this bear.
Wanna make love?
You wanna make love to this bear?
Hey,
to this bear,
make love. Get that ass split open by a bear.
This is fucking wild.
Go down, make in love in the woods with a fridge and a big brown bear and a pig and cat and Derek. You'll feel I'm not cool with how you invited Derek without consulting me. That boy ain't right.
Oh my god. Okay, wow. Jesus Christ. Well, it was different sets of footage, by the way, which does make sense. And yes, you are correct. It is a very Derek specific fact. But the reason why it's a Derek specific fact is because long, long ago, a young Anne would have been to one of these places that would have had the Rockfire gang. This is definitely not the same place. Well, it is the same place, this one, for this shot. But the other one is not the same because it's a completely different show. I mean, this show does exist, but they didn't have that. But I will say this. What they have right here, it's an easy to tell where this is because I actually would have been in this location long, long ago. And the reason why I know it's even weirder is because her left arm today is broken. They'll never fix it, but her right arm still works. Looks like Disney World? No. This is actually up in West Virginia. Because that's the Marshall logo. That's the Marshall logo. College football team. There you go. That's how you know. That's how you know that I know. That's how. If you've ever wanted to know, the one in the suspenders, one of the other ones also has a Marshall thing too. But they gave her pom-poms and they tried to make her a cheerleader. I think she had a different outfit before that. But it's kind of been that way for the longest time. At some point in the early 2000s, that thing broke and it doesn't work anymore. But they never repaired it. There was a whole documentary about this, about how they try and restore these things. The gorilla's goaded. Yeah, the gorilla's goaded. My parents took me to a Bob's once ever. Still have pics of it. Hey, didn't mean to derail you, but thank you. No, it was good. Trust me, you're derailing this. Him eating this. I'm not even excited for this. Like, I don't know. I kind of hoped he was going to do something more exciting, but this is the meal. Some potatoes.
I love
some
it. This is super good.
Noodles and some pork. That's too big for his mouth hole.
So many noodles.
It's literally what we got to look forward to. Are those places Appalachia specific? I think they were all out in the
Is it everything here is full of flavor?
I believe it was.
Except
what it was.
This macaroni salad. This macaroni salad is so bland.
As he takes another
It's like the pure bowl. Mayo.
Yeah, mayo for a mayo American like himself.
It's all I taste in the macaroni salad is pure mayo. It's so weird because everything else is so good.
You can have like a little thing of paprika or pepper or something. Spice it up? Nah. We don't need any of that. Just kind of complain about it.
Ashley Johansson says, I've eaten Korean food all my life, but never heard of macaroni salad. Again, I don't know.
Very nice to know.
But they include it with their platters. Maybe it's like a
bento box.
It's also a Hawaiian restaurant. Like they've got the Kalua pork. They've got spam musubi.
So this is the thing that he ordered from before.
So maybe they just include a macaroni salad with every combo or something. I don't know.
Yeah, this is like the place that he always orders from. So when I said, because I felt like I said it somewhere, I thought, okay, this guy's just going to get Hawaiian barbecue again. And he basically got Hawaiian barbecue again. Because, I mean, what is this? It's basically Hawaiian barbecue. Don't fucking try and dress up any other
way. Too quickie, I just became a super positive individual and subscribed.
Yeah, musubi is Hawaiian. It was like that spam thing that he had that one time that he complained about. But, I mean, it looked very standard. Something I'd see in Hawaii, I guess. I mean, this guy really doesn't know a lot of the outside world, so I can't really expect him to care.
Would I say Food J's better, worse, or the same one buzzed? My fork just snapped. What the hell? Made a noise.
It actually did snap it. Look at this.
One buzzed? Would I say Food J's better, worse, or the same one?
What is he doing?
Same one buzzed?
Holding it?
Would I say Food J's better, worse, or the...
Yeah, no, he just clicked it. He kind of clicked it with his fingernail.
Same one buzzed? My fork just snapped. What the hell? Made a noise.
My fork made a noise. Yeah, he's just fidgeting.
Depends.
It's...
Honestly?
Get out of here.
I've had food that tasted super amazing when I was buzzed, and other times you're so like I guess maybe not buzzed, but a little bit more than that, like almost drunk. You can't really enjoy the food because you can't taste it as well. You're too numbed from the alcohol, right? Have I ever had hibachi before? Yes. A couple times I've had hibachi grill food. When I lived in Connecticut, there was a couple hibachi restaurants that I went to with my friends.
Yes.
It's always fun when the local the guy puts on a show hibachis. For you as they're cooking, right?
I mean, he went to a hibachi grill here. He talked about it. I think it was like Kat's birthday 2 years ago. Not 2 years ago. Maybe it was a year ago.
But yes, Derek, you showed up late.
You know what? He actually did talk about it. Because it was like, it was after the failed Chiking thing. And then he did a hibachi grill and he complained about them, like, not having their chef there. And then they settled and went home for sushi.
This is the third time I've ordered from this restaurant.
And he said he's been there before.
I've had this particular meat once before.
Dude.
The other time that I ordered from here, I got bibimbap.
And he thought this was stir fry, by the way.
Mixed plate where you get the bulgogi.
Stir fry stuff in a Korean barbecue.
Three different interesting veggie sides. Like, one of them is like the kimchi cabbage, which is the fermented cabbage. One is this seaweed, like dried seaweed.
I mean,
and the other is something. What was the third one? It was something I don't even know what it was.
I don't care about this explanation. But when it comes to, like, DSP and his eating adventures and whatnot, I don't know. I'm kind of over it now because he's just being annoying with the food and the descriptions and everything. I hate when he describes anything, because, like, the only thing I've gotten from this is the rice tastes like rice. The glass noodles are, like, super good. The potatoes are potatoes. They soaked into something. You got to eat everything separately. And then the fucking the mayo stuff on the side, the salad, is, like, tastes like mayo. Like, that's all I've gotten from all of this. I really have nothing else that I need to add to this. Sushi chef at the hibachi place was out, so they had to order DoorDash sushi. Yeah, that was basically the story. I'm kind of glad that I can speed shit up now. Like, speed it up faster than two times. Look at this. Here we go. I don't even have to hear him anymore. Like, you can just see him just eating fast forward. Here he goes, gobble, gobble, gobble. Gobble, gobble, gobble. Come here. Oh, it's going too fast. Can't keep up. He did a thing. Today's autistic golf shirt. Hey, come on now. It's a great shirt. Don't shit on the shirt. It should have dual streamed dinner with Kat. You know why? If Kat was here, that would have made it more interesting. I kind of wish she was here. Yeah, I don't even have any interest to, like, watch this at normal speed. This should be, like, my thing that I should care about. He didn't even eat it all. Wait a minute. What?
It seems as hard to possibly eat all that meat. Like, that's incredible, you know? So there you go. All right, so how do I rate it? Someone says, how do you rate it? It's not the best thing I've ever had. It's pretty good value, and it's pretty tender, delicious meat. It's just the right amount of spice for me. Like,
what?
It's not overpoweringly spicy to the point where your mouth burns.
It was mid.
It gives you the spice while you're eating it, like, right
mid.
After you chew and swallow. You get a burn, and it kind
of
goes away. Like,
mid.
Right now, my mouth isn't spicy, which is good. I enjoyed
my
the spice while I was eating it.
Spicy.
I don't need to have insane, overwhelming spice in my mouth that's gonna last me the rest of the day, you know? I don't know why people like that. Some people do, but to me, I just want that spice when I'm eating the darn thing, right?
Does he know how spicy things work?
So, that was good. If I had to give it a number rating...
Touchdown! Look at that. If he had to give it a number rating, he would give it a touchdown out of 10.
I'd probably give it like 4 out of 5.
Whoa, look at that. 4 out of 5.
Why 4 out of 5? Because number one, the macaroni salad needs more flavor. It's bland. I don't know why it's so bland.
Okay. That was a negative.
And number two, because I feel like it is a little bit on the pricier side. But then again, I don't know what
expensive.
The markup is. You know, I paid like $18 for that. But ooh. I don't.
Holy sh. My brother in Christ, $18? What? Bro, I know inflation hit, but god damn. Holy shit. like half of that is like potatoes and rice. I got a fucking 25 pound bag of rice right now. And that cost me, well, it cost me a little bit of money, but like, come on, man. Rice ain't expensive. He did not get a, he, holy shit. He's not counting delivery. He's not counting tips. He's just counting what the plate was worth.
You know what the markup is for delivery. If I had ordered it at the restaurant, it could have been way cheaper. You never know with these apps.
You never know
how much they're marking the food up.
You so could have looked at the answer, restaurant, you know,
actually
menu.
The cost because I don't know. Right?
You could find
I
out.
I received a $4.20.
Okay, I don't really care about the money segment. So he just stops eating after this. He walks away for like 20 minutes. And then he looks at videos of himself. What kind of videos do we look at? Oh my God. We're gonna have to refresh. Oh, I refreshed too early. Look at that. Refreshed way too early. What's Tevin doing? Tevin's surviving. Shybot doing. Shybot surviving too. That's pretty good. I wanna see what kind of cool videos we looked at.
Posed a playlist of 29 videos. That
okay, Shattered Dimensions. Else we see
out and doing quite like silly things to knock out the guards, right?
It's Batman. This way I always order takeout. The rare times I don't want to cook, you know what, like I'll order takeout, but like I don't use DoorDash. I use DoorDash maybe like twice a year, maybe three times a year max, but I'd rather just go pick it up. I'm sick, you know, whatever. Resident Evil 5 Lost Nightmares, PS4 launch, Need for Speed Rivals. At 29 videos. Worst game I ever played, Homefront the Revolution. Yeah, it's not a, he just kind of sucks his own dick on that. Assassin's Creed Brotherhood multiplayer game part 1. Wait, did we even, oh shit, look at this. Oh, I want to actually see his reaction to this video. Is actually shaping up to be good.
And I always played it and enjoyed it. Maybe they just thought that the investment into it, the money it took to develop it, was too much money and they didn't feel like doing it. The only other time they did multi,
I only care about the one react that's coming out. Oh God, when is it?
Again, we're doing this level of video, okay? Whether you're
all right, here we go.
Burning,
I want to hear him. Like react to himself.
And then I think
up.
They'll wrap this up for us. Let's see what the next one is.
Really didn't even do 29 videos.
Look at this.
Barely did any of them.
Oh.
Whoa.
What's up, everyone? DSP
didn't see
here.
There.
Thinking around. I went to get my drink and the camera started already. Oh.
Oh my God. Look at me. Oh my God. Yo, I look absolutely terrible.
He had a lot more hair.
Look at this. My hair is overgrown. Yeah. And looks atrocious. I have pimples all over my face. My beard is overgrown and not trimmed. This looks awful.
Late
20s pimples,
man.
It's like Paul Bunyan Burnell, right? My old shirt, which is one of my old pieces of product that I used to sell off of Cafe Press. Yeah.
Can you tell us what it says?
Really important, this video.
Hey,
okay?
Remember when he tried to bring back the mug?
If, why am I holding this?
Takes a sip. Delicious.
If you are at all.
What's funny is some people are like, oh, your voice was higher pitched. In reality, maybe a little. But what it is I always used a camera, and that camera is just a digital camera's tiny little mic. It doesn't pick up bass at all. Like, if you listen to all my things back then, there's zero bass. Zero. It's just all treble. That's just only up the high notes of my voice, not the rest of my voice. So now, my voice is good. Last 10 years, I've had bass in a year. I've
seen footage of video games on the internet of any sort. Whether
the hate shirt really ties it
video
together.
Clips of playthroughs, whether we're talking live streaming playthroughs, streaming of tournaments like Street Fighter tournaments, StarCraft tournaments.
What are you doing right now?
Call of Duty
tournaments. People he has watching. 400.
We're even talking, not bad. I'm not joking. We're even talking coverage of E3 video of
I should do my my
that's just going
game.
Over the internet. There is a bill that was created that is currently being debated on by Congress. There's, I guess it's up for approval or whatever, and possibly will be signed into law.
Such
when
great
I the light,
lighting.
I was using natural light from outside, and what keeps happening in this video is the sun keeps going on my screen light up.
The bill is S.978, okay?
Big up to S.
Here's what the intent of the bill is. The bill is intending that they don't want people streaming TV, movies, that kind of copyrighted content over the internet, because Hollywood and the, you know, these studios are worried about it. They're worried that they're losing profits because people are doing this kind of stuff over the internet. Now, what the goal of the bill is to not only make it illegal, but to have very serious legal consequences for this. Number one, you could possibly have massive civil fines, which we're talking thousands upon thousands of dollars. And number two, you could actually go to jail for this. I believe it's like up to 5 years you can go to jail.
I don't know if he started deepening his voice. People 13, made 12, fun
13
of him.
Years ago. So,
yeah.
You know, this is around, what, 2011-ish?
Yeah. 2012-ish?
Something like that? Something like that. Yeah.
Yeah.
I can understand
you don't have...
where they're coming from there with...
He doesn't have to worry about copyright with himself. Kind of just is, let it play. Why did he even tell us that? Just talk over it.
Okay. What I don't understand is that this bill,
years ago.
If it goes through the way it's
really, thank
right
you.
Now,
I'm so glad you told us.
Will actually also apply to video games, because video games are considered copyrighted works. Now, as of right now...
So why did this video get 747,000 views? Because I was one of a few content creators who spoke up about it in a way like this. Like,
I don't actually think this is 100% true. Bill S978. What happens when we look up Bill S978? There were other people that also produced videos too. David Angel got about 500,000 views. This one only got a few. 156,000. YouTube USA did, but he only had 16K. I guess he's trying to tout that he was the biggest person that said anything about it. Wow, this was 12 years ago with Minecraft footage. Holy crap. That's like old school shit. I mean, he can tout that he was the biggest, I suppose, but I don't know if that's 100%. There were a lot of other people that talked about it, though. You know, don't think about it too much. Let him toot his horn.
Some people were mentioning it in their content, but I
heard about
the bill.
There are a lot of people.
And I spoke up
about
it in this video, and the video went viral on YouTube. I didn't get millions of views, but I got hundreds of thousands of views. It was shared by a ton of people who then made their own videos, and everyone just started talking about it. It actually became a big debate.
Yeah, DSP
in the realm of gaming at the time. Actually, what ended up happening was the bill, I think the bill, it either didn't pass, or when it did get passed, they changed it, so it didn't affect anything in that way.
I didn't even know what happened
okay?
to it.
But what was funny was, people
didn't
saw
even
this
know
video
what happened to it.
As one of the big
just,
instrumental things
yeah,
that
I don't know what happened to the bill, but you know, I was a big
of,
proponent against it. I fucking hated that
because
bill.
Because of the awareness
I wanted it
of
to
that
die.
It was going to possibly change the whole internet. And I actually
don't even know where I went.
Got contacted by a nonprofit like activist group.
Whoa.
And
what
they
did
were
they
like,
say?
So, you know, you were one of the instrumental people sharing information about this on the internet, and we're actually doing a book or documentary about it.
Yeah? Were you part
would
of
you
it?
Would you like to be in it?
I
and
said
I was
no.
Like,
I said no.
What do you mean? They're like, we want to like, interview you, and we want to have you be
bro.
Like in it. I was
yeah?
like, no. I remember.
They were like, Bill, you're doing such a good job on spreading the message. Would you like to be part of this documentary to talk about this thing they were talking about? No, I don't want to do that at all. I just want to play video games. I don't know what you're talking about.
You know, keep in mind, this was 12, 13 years ago. I was like,
holy
no.
shit.
I mean, I spoke up because I felt like it was very important that people
right?
need to know about this issue. Keep in mind, this was before the internet hated me. This was before, this is how you don't play.
Yeah.
This was before all the memes about me. People liked me back then.
Yeah.
So when I made this video, people were actually like, oh, this is important. DSP's speaking up about something, right? Today, if I made a video like this, it would get like 1,000 views and no one would care and everyone would laugh at me because I'm just an internet meme now.
Yeah.
So I have lost my ability to help people because of morons on the internet. I mean, just...
But you physically did not help. Yes, you spread the word, and then when it came time for you to help somebody out, you did nothing. You also didn't follow up with what the fuck was going on. You don't even know what happened to the bill. So what's the point of even like promoting yourself and patting yourself on the back? I did my job. When you clearly didn't even care enough to kind of help a nonprofit. What the fuck?
Think about that. I used to have clout to be able to go out and spread the word about important issues.
So wild.
And now I don't have that ability ever again because idiots wanted to make fun of me on the internet and ruin that for me. And for everyone, honestly, because I feel like there are things that I know about that I can help people with, but I can't anymore. You know, that's how people want it. It's more important to have the joke than to have something meaningful, right? But anyway, yeah, that's why this is so popular, because people really got alerted to the issue by me talking about it, and then they shared the video, made their own video, spread the awareness, and it went really well. I'm happy. This is one of like the two times ever in my run.
In your run?
When this has happened. And I was able to change things for the better, okay? Bro. Outside of that, we keep going, but as you can see, it's more Arkham. That was actually the demo for Batman Arkham Asylum.
Bro.
Next is John and I doing DC Universe Online again at the launch of PS4. So quite a few of the PS4 launch videos that we did got clout and viewership. What's funny is that also was the only time we ever played DC Universe Online. I never played it again after that launch day. But yeah, I mean, take a look. More Lost in Nightmares. My funniest gaming moments countdown from 2009, right? Shire and Web of Shadows Part 2. This is really cool. Got tons of views on doing a Royal Rumble sim, which was really neat. One of our 2013 Rumble sims before I moved. John and I did one. What's funny is this is just my channel trailer. Like, this is literally just the trailer from the Dark Side Filled channel to say what it was.
And
it
got so many views. It's
one of my top
few
videos of all time. So as you can see, when you go into my history
influential,
you know,
I was very
cool
back
in the day that got popular, it was innovative stuff. You know, some of the earliest co-op ever that inspired other people to do co-op, literally YouTube shorts or clips of highlights of the game rather than actual full playthrough of the game, which then people asked for the full playthrough, which is why I started doing the full raw playthroughs. Video essay style video.
Video
8 years ago, before it was
prominent
on YouTube.
Video.
I mean, this is all stuff that I was doing over the years. The thing is, I always felt more comfortable just playing
pretending
games and being
to be
a normal
innovator.
Guy.
Is he literally pretending to be an innovator? DSP was a copycat through and through. He didn't just start the documentaries. He didn't start talking about the bills. This is not all invented by DSP. He picked it up as he went along. He couldn't even compete in the gaming category. He literally put himself in comedy. That's how he competed back in the day. This is fucking wild.
And out with you guys are having fun with the game rather than doing all those things that became YouTube popular.
This is almost
facts,
like a stolen valor moment.
I never followed those waves of those things that other people did, so it is what it is, but hey,
it is what it is.
I hope that
it
you enjoyed
popular,
me reacting to my
popular.
Top videos of all time. This is a fun series. Right. If ever people wanted me to continue this later down the line, we could do it.
If anybody wanted me to continue this, bro, you had a whole marathon dedicated to this. You fucking talked for 2 hours. You talked for an additional hour. You played Helldivers for an hour. You ate some food for an hour. You looked at some videos for an hour, and now you're playing Street Fighter. So the biggest of ups, we really just didn't do any. Oh my God, he's not here. What happened? Is the brownies ready?
All right. Well, good stuff. An hour of geef. Got a little bit of gameplay in. Sadly, don't remember half the stuff. Like I remember when you do the wall bounce with geef in the corner, that's when you get a big combo. I just don't remember how to do it. I think it's now I'm remembering it actually.
It's just a
when
short
wall
stream
bounce, you do a
just a short
punch,
stream
EX lariat.
Are we really
and then
doing
after the EX lariat you can do the aerial EX 360, so
oh,
it takes
man.
Two EX
yeah
meters,
it is a very nothing day
giant damage in the corner.
We literally
now
didn't do
it.
Shit
of course I remember it after
hey that's
I'm
pretty
done.
Good though. $650 for doing nothing.
All right guys,
man, we didn't even wear
good
a
stuff.
Hat
I hope
or
you
a vest.
Enjoyed the gift
you know
of
what
on my birthday.
We didn't even wear glasses. We paid him $650. He didn't take shots. He didn't wear glasses. He didn't wear a vest. Nothing. We just gave him like birthday money. He just shook out the cards and shook down everybody for money.
Birthday?
That's kind of lame.
Street Fighter 6 coming in the future. Thanks.
All right. Thanks.
Okay. All right, guys. This is the finale.
Oh, my God. Derek got cut.
Let's go ahead.
All right. While we're doing the finale, I'm going to do the unboxing of Mio.
And
while he's eating a fucking brownie.
And I'm gonna have a piece of my birthday brownie, and then that's it.
Hopefully you're ready for the birthday brownie. He's ready to clock the fuck out.
Let's go full screen here.
He doesn't care. Dude is checked out. He got his money. He didn't even have to do any drinking.
I did pretty good with Zangief, which is good.
He was buzzed.
Yep. All right. This is going to be the adjournment of the birthday marathon.
How much did he drink?
Piece of my birthday brownie. How many fluid ounces? And kind of hang out with you guys for
a few more
minutes.
That's the same cup, by the way.
And then that's the marathon.
Same bim-bop cup.
Then I got a lot of uploading to do. Whoa. I got to upload all these videos.
You see that corner demon? Look at that.
And then that's the marathon. Okay. Yes. Then I got a lot of.
Whoa. Corner demon down there. Watch out. Coming to get you.
A lot of uploading to do. I gotta upload all these videos to the various channels. I gotta set up the big playlist for the React show tomorrow. I got a million things I gotta fucking do before I can get out of here tonight.
Wow. One actual right. million
So I'll be
things.
Back. I'm just gonna mute the mic. I'll be right back.
Okay. How long? Are we still away? Yeah. No. He's just still away. Okay. Great. No, he's just gone. He's checked the fuck out. All right. Well, while we're waiting for him to come back, I'm going to do the unboxing of Mio. I'm gonna do this. Maybe I should put him up. I don't know. Yeah, we'll put him up here. There we go. We'll put him up here and chill out. Hello, everybody. We got for you today, Mio. Shit. don't think about that. Yeah, the little octopus. Little octopus is here. It's in angry mode. Actually, you know what? I'm in happy mode. Then we got Dingus's little crocheted whale. Obviously. We love the whale. We also got the shot glass. I like the shot glass. It's a very good shot glass. Very trusty. I gotta wash out the blow me for luck though. This one, we gotta run this. We gotta run this and wash this because we used this recently. I can't remember when. We definitely did use this. This is the Vegas blow me for luck. All right, while we wait for DSP to come back, and he'll have his brownie, we can watch him up at the top. But we got the cat. The cat has finally arrived. It's pretty cool. We got Mio. A game that I didn't even finish, by the way. Don't worry, Dingus will make me finish the game. I'll eventually play it and finish it all the way through to completion. At some point, it'll happen. I have nicely. No, I need a. They need to be trimmed a little bit. They're not trimmed at all. These are not. They're not trimmed. I gotta. Yeah. I'm actually embarrassed about it. Post game and. Nah. Oh, wait a minute. Don't you dare make me do too much now. Post game and everything? That's literally asking for the world. Can you imagine that? Post game and everything. These are one of the few times where I didn't get a second. You know, I always think about it as like, do I want to get a second box for this? Because Figmas are Figmas, man. I like Figmas. They're very affordable for what they are. They're little figurine style situation type deal, obviously. Take Mio out of her cage or plastic. Holy shit, look at that. Get the little fucking nonsense in there. I guess you kind of can't see it with a reflection. I gotta be careful. Like, I gotta reflect it this way so you can't see what's going on. I don't need you accidentally seeing, you know. Too many reflections around here. Yes, you are supposed to open it. I'm not one of those people that don't open these things, obviously. We have to have these open. there are some people that are like, oh, I gotta keep it in its box. I don't want it to ever leave its box. It's like, no, come on, man. It has to leave its box. I don't have many Figmas, but the ones I do, I kind of like to have them out and about. This one I'm kind of like really tempted not to, though.
Well, I'm exhausted. It's been a long day. I've been in here since 10:30.
Very posable.
Almost 8:30. Oh, man. All right.
Oh, I got a burp stuck in me, too.
Likes isang libot labing isang has redeemed the following TTS message.
Alright guys, are you ready to adjourn?
When Bear Rock does his first run video, will we watch that in place of Anime Night?
No. I do not want to watch that in place of Anime Night. Hello,
everybody. Well, it's been
Welcome to my birthday.
It's been a fun marathon.
It's been fun.
I've been here since 10:30 this morning.
I don't know if I want to call it fun.
Fun podcast.
It definitely was a marathon.
But
it definitely wasn't worth one Helldivers up 2, for. I mean,
right,
checking out now
food, so Korean barbecue,
nice, but, you know.
Reacted to my most popular YouTube videos of all time. Discovered that I was doing trends way before the trends were trends. And
I
then
was doing
Street
trends
Fight. So
before
what a heck of a day.
Trends.
I think a little bit for everyone.
What?
You know, gameplay,
dude, DSP was a trendsetter.
Vlogging.
He didn't capitalize
this is the
on
finale.
It, though. Everybody else did it better
what
than him.
What I'm going to do right now is have a brownie that my wife made.
And make sure that, like...
But I don't think that the frosting solidified yet.
What?
Basically, it's a chocolate brownie.
Holy crap. Hold on. Look at that. Oof. It's definitely a brownie, but, you know, it's kind of... What did we do? Did we put apples? Is this like an apple caramel? What did we do? Okay. Alright. Big ups to the... Whatever this is.
Brownie with a peanut butter frosting and crushed nuts. Crushed peanuts on top.
Those are peanuts!
And it looks good, smells great, but definitely the frosting is gooey. Like, you can tell it needs to be in the fridge more to solidify more. So, it's fine, because what happened is, of course, she frosted it when it was out of the oven, so it's probably too warm to solidify yet, and it just hasn't sat in the fridge long enough. But flavor-wise, it's probably going to be good. It smells good. All right, so this is my birthday cake this year. No cake this year, but instead a brownie with some peanut butter. Let's see.
You know what? This will probably be one of these cases where I will remove her, but I probably will put her back. I don't know if I want to display Mio. I displayed Diva, but Diva was kind of like a, you know,
that's
Diva's whack. Diva.
Thanks for giving a membership, and it went to Toasty Ghost.
Diva's
congrats,
like,
Toasty Ghost.
You know.
Okay.
Bean will probably have something for something to say about me dissing Diva. I mean, Diva's fine, but you know, it's Diva, come on. Now I'm excited because we have long hair attachment. We also have the ring blades.
The frosting. Didn't solidify like I said.
Blades. We got two of them.
Those
we have
frosting.
The flute. Oh my gosh, I can't pop this thing out.
You need times to harden. If it hardens, it's going to be perfect. I've had brownies just like this before. The brownie part tastes amazing.
Situation type deal.
It's nice. It's moist, chocolatey, but definitely the peanut butter frosting needs more.
We have her little
cool, but it
book?
Will. It's in the fridge right now. Just a matter of time, I guess.
Little tiny book.
If you think about it, we ate around 4:30-ish.
And we have the
so
different
she really
faces.
Had 3 hours, and she
we
probably
have...
made them.
Oh, God.
They probably took
oh,
about,
yeah. This is where
like,
all
like,
our different
like
hands 15, are.
20 minutes to do the batter, probably half an hour to bake. So really, it
the different
been in the
hand
for 2 hours,
attachment.
And that's probably why. So, anyway. But it tastes great. The peanut butter flavor is good.
Figure
I like
setup? No, I don't.
Top.
I don't
and, it's
collect figures as
I
much anymore. I do have some older figures. Let me see. Let me grab some. I'll show you what I mean. What I mean by that is... Wait. This doesn't count, but it does count at the same time.
Mm. It's good.
You know how
personally,
DSP
I really like
has like...
I think they're tasty. So,
DSP has the axe
my style.
That he has like at his doorway and
okay.
everything.
with the crunchy.
Whenever somebody like breaks in or whatever.
What's wrong with paper plates? Anyone want to elaborate on that? Since
this is what Dingus sent me. This is my axe. Literally my axe.
You know, it's not like my wife didn't just completely make this from scratch.
It's heavy.
Had to wash a ton of dishes.
And if I needed to, I could bash somebody with this. I could actually kill somebody with this. That's pretty good.
Actually, like wash dishes because we don't have a working dishwasher. It's been broken for years. You know, do a nice thing. Just use a paper plate and throw it out. Don't have to wash it. Oh no, but you know, paper plates on your birthday, right? That's a big deal. You're an idiot.
Wow.
You're good. Of all the things in life to be worrying about, you're worrying about paper plates. I mean, no brain, right? Exactly, bring out the fine china to eat your birthday brownies on. It's such a big deal,
right? Switch it up really quick.
Such a huge deal. So,
you're doing that right now, duh.
What did you guys think of the marathon today? Since we're adjourning here, what was everyone's favorite part of the marathon? I'm curious. I want to hear, what did you guys think was the best part?
Hey now.
Jade, welcome back. Call me a mouthful of brownie. Digiball Gaming is happy I read a super chat. Maximum Turbo says, for me, the podcast and the Street Fighter 6. Felix the Maid liked the reacting. Did I drink? Yeah, I had two drinks today. I had a mojito and I had a Long Island iced tea. Kyakak liked the podcast the most, then Street Fighter 6, then Helldivers, in that order. Jail liked the reacting. Everyone just likes different things, see? But that's a good thing about a marathon like this, is a little bit of something for everybody. Right? Like someone had said, the problem with me, with everyone saying they want more gaming, is that no one agrees on the games. Right? Like, oh, I want Phil to play more games, but what game? Well, one person wants an RPG, one person wants a fighting game, one person wants this. When I do a marathon, I get to do a little bit of everything. And because of that, it kind of appeases everyone. Which is a good thing. Mm-hmm. Are you still talking about paper plates? Seriously. You really want to talk about paper plates? You're that stupid. Someone actually is still talking about paper plates in the chat. I mean, you want to be the most detail-oriented idiot. I'm sitting here at the end of my birthday marathon and being nice to people, asking, what did you like? Someone actually talk about paper plates again. Wow.
You're doing that right now, duh.
What's my birthday wish? I don't have a birthday wish. I never did that. Never said make a wish. Like, what am I wishing for? It's my birthday. I'm already having a celebration. What else am I wishing for? Right? Listen, I just got to spend the day with a cool audience, hanging out, doing a variety of things I like to do. Tons of support for the channel. This is going to help the channel long term in a huge way. With the amount of stuff that came in today, seriously, it's going to help a lot. Which is awesome.
I'm back.
Now I'm going to upload and I get to spend time with my wife tonight. I get to actually leave here a little bit earlier.
I wanted to show
Aquasaver
one of the
figures. Extra time with my wife.
Specifically Aquasaver.
What? And tomorrow I get to get up and do it all again. I get to have another fun day with you guys.
Hey, where's his cake?
What more could I want?
You already ate it?
You know? Right now,
dude,
I'm happy.
I only stepped away for a second.
Right now, I'm happy. I'm not thinking about what else I want, what else I'm wishing for.
Oh,
right? That's ridiculous.
A wishing segment. Sniff, sniff.
Ate while I ate Dr. Shouting
out.
Yeah.
Oh my God, help! Manche, why are you yelling? Why are you shouting out these ladies? Don't you know? I could be married. Oh my Lord, these ladies have... They're insane. Insanity. I mean, all these ladies. Is she currently streaming right now? I don't care. We're not giving her a shout out again.
Is she is? Another haiku.
Oh my God, no, I don't care about the fucking haikus. Get out of here.
A flood. My throwback channel with too many videos. Already once a day there's a gameplay video. And okay. I'll probably do one
Here's
a day for the
thing
next
that
few
I
days.
Wanted to show.
I don't
want to
go crazy and upload like three of those videos. Plus a new gameplay video. Then tomorrow we're going to have the Walking Dead stuff. I'll space it out. Everything else though should go live today. I think today, tonight, and tomorrow are her uploads, of course.
There's your saber figure. I had to look for this one. Oh, shit. It's a saber figure. It's pretty beefy.
Yummy. There's some more shout-outs to do. I'll do them in a second when I finish my cake.
You can tell what
Excuse
kind
me,
of...
my brownie.
I didn't have too many figures, but the figures I used to collect, you can tell what kind of things I was into back in the day. It's Gohaku.
Okay, I can actually talk now.
Yeah, you can see the stuff that I was into back in the day. But I don't collect figures no more. Those are all old figures that I've had like forever and ever.
Oh, let's see. Happy birthday, Phil, from one Aries to another. I wish it would have been there for some of your birthday stream, but I just got home from work.
Be really
I was working since 2 p.m. Eastern time. Hope it all went well. I'll take two tequila shots for you. We'll enjoy your tequila shots.
Join.
Thank you for the $6 tip. I don't know who you are because you didn't leave your name. But I hope you had a good day at work as well. And thank
you
very much.
We're going
to
pop off Neo's head.
Let's see here. I got a $5 super chat from Spawn Killer. Happy birthday. Crazy how when you started YouTube, you were only 27.
Okay, and we're
going
to swap the face.
I was younger than that. I was 20... Technically, I think my first YouTube video was uploaded when I was 25.
We'll use a happy face.
And then I started regularly uploading when I was 26.
All you have to do is like slot it in.
I think. I'm pretty sure. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure I was 26 when I first started as a hobby. That would have been what, 2008?
Slot it in.
And then I turned 27 in 2009.
Pop the hair back.
Yeah. I was even younger? I don't know. I can't figure it out. It's too long of a day. I can't do math in my head right now. Let's see here. Danny, the $10 super chat says, happy birthday. The brownie looks good. Makes me want to whip up a batch of brownies myself. Cheers to 42. Thank you so much, Danny. Dr. Oink with a $2 super chat. What did you enjoy most
Danny.
Of your birthday?
And I have a different name.
What? Of your birthday?
Imagine it was Danny.
Oh,
Danny,
oh, today.
$10.
You're asking questions like the past. You're talking about today.
Let me do this without.
Let me think. Let's see. Out of everything
I
today.
Want to ruin anything? I hate like resocketing heads.
Man, everything was fun. You know what I mean? Like literally everything was fun that we did.
Resocketed. We got
I
the long
can't
hair
think
mode.
Of something
yes,
that we did that I
did not enjoy.
These individual
segments kind of move.
You know.
That's kind of wild.
What I'm happy is that everything. Went without a hitch. As you noticed, there was no drama whatsoever today.
No
derailing, no trolling. They tried. Yeah, if they failed, as
they
usual,
tried.
They have no power over me anymore, which
Nobody
is great.
Cared about this segment. The segment was fucking
you know,
worthless.
Everything, all the gameplay went pretty good, right? It was
you had
fun.
2 hours of gameplay. And
the
it
reacting
was
fun and not boring. We actually discovered some interesting stuff during the reacting about
we fucked
my past
over
and
Derek.
Stuff that I used to do. And likely how it inspired
over
others
Derek.
To do things.
Which is kind of cool.
Right? Like,
kinda
I'm thinking, like, everything. This was
Fuck
really good.
Derek.
The brownie is delicious. The dinner was good. I don't think I have a single thing to complain about today. Right? Even the podcast, it went extra long. But it went extra long because we were all having a good time. We were talking.
Bro.
People were being very generous and contributing.
Can't complain.
We were having just a good interactive day.
Bucks.
That's the best day.
Why would he complain?
We didn't
think he was
going to
get about fucking
any crazy schedule. Where we absolutely had to do certain things, right? Instead, it was more of a casualized day, and it worked because of that. I like the more casualized things that we do, for sure.
I think we're going
to
do
These
the open
best.
Hands. We'll do the open hand ones.
Do I feel like I was still a kid in my 30s? Mentally, yes. You know, mentally, my life was really messed up.
Phil's mentally been a child forever.
Like I told you, in my 20s, I was like straight up hard, dark, hardcore depressed. I hated my life.
What?
I hated my everything about me. I didn't know where my life was going. I kind of had given up.
This is a segment.
I didn't have any determination of what I wanted to do with my life. I had no goals or anything. Nothing.
He shouldn't be talking about this.
You know, all of a sudden, in my late 20s, into early 30s, I stumble upon YouTube fame. And it's so weird because people care about me and what I'm doing and everything.
Yeah, I guess he did.
It was just very different.
People cared about me. They didn't care about me before.
It was the first time in my life that I felt like there was some value to what I was doing with it. Because people were genuinely enjoying me and my presence and my content.
She has little stumps now.
Telling me how much it meant to them. And it
she
was
has stumps.
And everything.
Help!
Okay, well, but you know, for me, I still had kind of a more immature mindset. I mean, come on. I was sitting around playing video games all day.
Yeah,
right?
He's still kind
of
immature
today.
It
wasn't until, I'd argue, the last decade of my life. Really, I would say that. That would really where...
He matured up.
When
he
I moved out
off.
Here, and a lot of harsh realities of life hit me in the
face.
He had,
like, two ladies?
And I started seeing things in different
ways. That were moms for him?
From a more mature perspective.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
You know, I guess what they say, too, is, you know, you're not... You don't actually see someone's true character until they're facing
adversity.
You're
doing that right now, dude!
I don't feel like I faced any adversity until I moved out.
Okay. I want you to listen to this. Listen to this.
Is, you know, you don't actually see someone's true character until they're facing adversity. I don't feel like I faced any adversity until I moved out here and then public opinion changed about me.
DSP thinks public opinion only changed about him when he moved out. It had already started to change before he moved out. It did play a factor, but it's not the 100% end-all be-all factor of what changed. And that's a weird thing of adversity, because that's not necessarily adversity. That's just showcasing how you yourself just wasn't doing a good job anymore. You were kind of failing at your job. You weren't as popular anymore. And how did you overcome it? You didn't. You just kept doing the same thing over and over again. And then you had to file for bankruptcy after you jacked off on stream. And you lost your first girlfriend and you got a new girlfriend and you married her and she got really, really fat. So, I mean, in reality, in the realest of realities, the adversity was all self-administered. You didn't have to, but you did it anyway. So, I don't know. Maybe you should have not been a piece of shit? Maybe.
Right? Up to then, it was like, and yes, in my life, it was, there was, I wasn't happy with
he's
myself
really
in my life. As
trying
as the YouTube thing
to,
started, it was
making
just
a
like,
fake
success.
Fucking narrative. Anybody's been around,
and
too.
And fun, and uploading, and then as soon as,
if Derek can tell you when this shit started. Derek's been around forever. This is so lame. This is so wild. He knows when the fucking This Is How You Don't Play started. He knows that This Is How You Don't Play. Hold on. Metal Gear Solid 2 is when it really, really fucking started. This was 11 years ago. Like, the original thing happened in 2013. He didn't move yet. He was still in... you know, Connecticut. So you can't pretend that it just all of a sudden started when you moved. No, it definitely ramped up when he moved, because he was basically burning the bridges of every single connection he had to everybody in his life. He was saying, fuck you to the fans, fuck you to Connecticut, fuck you to John, fuck you to Howard, fuck you to everything. It is so lame. This is a cringeworthy moment. A gamer accidentally live streamed an intimate moment of self-love while assuming that his webcam was off. YouTuber who goes by the name of DSP Gaming found himself sharing more than he'd like when he failed to check whether his camera was on during the X-rated self-love session. That was probably the Watch Mojo thing too, wasn't it? But yeah, it definitely started before This Is How You Don't Play. This Is How You Don't Play is a symptom of what people were feeling about DSP and how he used to call himself the king of hate and how he used to shit on people. He used to have whole segments of where he would just shit on you for like wanting to be his friend on Xbox. So it's kind of lame how he likes to pretend this came out of nowhere and out of left field. In reality, in actual reality, this is all self-inflicted.
The adversity hit me. Financial troubles. People hating on me on the internet don't like me anymore. All this shit happening at once. Relationship troubles and my personal life is falling apart.
Bro,
when all that happened,
relationship troubles didn't happen in 2014. Relationship troubles started happening in 2017? Literally in 2017. The bankruptcy wasn't even a thing until, you know.
It changed me, you know? And I feel like I became a better person.
I'm glad
I got through it.
Leveled up.
And
we're still on level one, but you know, we leveled up.
Then I matured.
We got experience.
And I became a more serious person.
We became
and realized things that I said. The word I say has weight and gravity.
Smiley Neo.
The actions speak louder than words, right?
Actions speak louder than words.
Now, you just stick to my guns, excuse me.
These words
when
right here.
To
the words I'm carrying
like the
right now.
That I wanted to make. And I wanted to not be harmful to others. Instead, I just wanted to stay in my lane and do stuff for my viewers and fans and not become some kind of a drama-causing, controversial figure.
Wait,
despite
what?
Despite the fact that everyone else wanted to pull me in that direction.
Wait, what?
Stay in my lane and do stuff for my viewers and fans and not become some kind of a drama-causing, controversial figure. Despite the fact that everyone else wanted to pull me in that direction.
He literally made people hate him because of Project 7. He made people hate him because of how he would go on weird racial tangents. He made people hate him because of how much of a mockery he made of gaming as a whole. He didn't foster a good community, he fostered a hateful community. Those people that liked him and liked to laugh with him started laughing at him because he kind of was a piece of crap. Staying in his lane means insulting LTG. Yeah, he literally insulted LTG for plugging 2 weeks ago. But here we were literally plugging yesterday. So it's so lame how he likes to pretend he's taking a high road, that he's changed. He's literally doing the thing that he does every single time whenever he gets called out on a thing. I changed, dude. I've evolved. I've become better. I'm a different person. I'm not the same DSP that I was 5 minutes ago. You know?
No, but yeah, like I would say I don't feel like I grew up.
Yeah, he grew
until
up.
Maybe 10 years ago.
He grew up in his 30s.
With, oh crap, all this serious stuff is
it
happening
now. It only
took
until 30 years old
and
to
now
grow
I gotta
up.
Figure out serious solutions.
And we're still acting like
it,
a
right?
kid, by the way. We still play video games.
I changed
games.
My whole life when you really think
he
about
said,
it.
That's like acting
I changed
like a
my
kid.
Whole life around.
Yeah,
right?
For Cat.
I started, essentially, I keep
Cat.
Saying this, like 2017.
Yeah, for Cat.
Was like a reboot button for my
yeah,
life.
Yeah, reboot.
Right? That's the year that I met my now wife. That's the year that I changed my
we
content.
We lost
Leanna,
got himself a horse. Pitched up, we're good to go.
With this over-the-top commentary that was just really immature.
It was still around.
Instead, I became a more interactive guy, more nice guy.
Interactive.
Right? The stream started to have more
doing that right now, dude. Bro.
In my opinion, anyway.
This is...
And,
this
you know,
is so ridiculous.
I faced a lot more hardships there, financial stuff, and I got through that. So,
how did you
for
get
me,
through it?
You know, when I look at all this, I'm like, okay.
You didn't get through it
now
alone.
Now I'm there. Now I'm out where I wanted to be in
you
my life.
You guys helped me,
up,
right?
I matured. I'm a better person, better content creator.
You helped
creator,
me level up.
But it took a while. When I started this, I feel like I was kind of an immature kid, for sure.
An immature kid at 30 years old. What a thing to admit.
Now I got a tickle in my throat that won't go away.
Oh, yeah.
I wonder if a piece of peanut
all right,
went down the wrong way.
Right now,
my
all right, we're going to keep Neo in the box. I've thought about it. Neo's going to stay in the box for right now. I don't want
mulch
her to
man. Happy
sit
birthday.
Out.
I normally recommend mulch,
I'm
but not
a little
for birthday
actually
cake.
Afraid.
It's highly flammable, but mulch your weeds. Mulch
we're
the weeds. You don't want to mulch weeds. You don't want weeds to grow. Mulch would make weeds grow. Absolutely not. I'm not going to mulch the weeds. I would mulch... nice herbs and plants and flowers. I would not mulch the weeds. Thank you for that, though.
ESP, the king
let's see
of gardening.
Here. GunkGlobal.com did a super
Gunk
chat and says,
Global.
Phil, I am happy birthday. I'm recovering from L4, L5 surgery. This is perfect. You mentioned a handcart previously that might help. What in the holy hell are you talking about?
A handcart. Yo.
This is a dumb meme that idiots have said back in the past about some
handcart. He literally has a handcart, and to this day, we make it a big deal when people bring it up, but he showed it off. He literally showed it off. And now he gets weird whenever anybody brings up the handcart. because he thinks it's a detractor meme. Well, yeah, anything could be a detractor meme when you think about it, but he's the one who talked about it. He showed it off. He has it. Oh my God. It's like pretending he doesn't have the little wheelie carts right behind him and saying that I don't have those. I don't know what those are.
Handcart. I don't know what you're talking about. I haven't used a handcart. You know, last time I probably used one was in over 10 years ago in Connecticut. So I don't know what you're talking about. I guess it's some kind of a dumb meme. Okay, I'll ignore you now.
Imagine taking offense. You know what?
Happy birthday. Thank you.
I actually would love somebody to ask him whether or not he still has his cool ass paintings in his fucking bedroom and see whether or not he takes offense to that. You think DSP would take offense at somebody inspecting what he used to have in his fucking bedroom? Yeah, probably. He actually would. 100% he would. But I'd still love somebody to ask it. I want to know if DSP still has the titty painting. Still hanging up. I wonder if Kat knows what that painting is. You think if Kat knew what that painting was, you think that she'd like tell him to take it down? Maybe.
Vietnamese comrade. I appreciate that. All right, so guys, it's the end of the marathon. Vietnamese
comrade.
Does anyone have any final thoughts? Anything you'd like to talk about?
Yeah, final thoughts.
Comments. Last minute contributions. Anything to shout out? Anything now?
You killed off Derek's suggestion. Now or forever hold your peace
because I'm about to get out of here for today. It's been a long day. Look at him. He's rushing. Then I have to do a playlist.
Get him out of here. Get him the fuck out of here. Tomorrow's React
show as well.
Derek's
so excited. I got a lot of stuff that I have to do before I can even get out of here. I probably won't even get out of this office. No exaggeration. Until like 10 p.m. So.
Woe is him.
Jade, yes, Street Fighter was all right tonight. I played with Zangief for a little over an
Jade,
hour.
Jade, I thought you were going to be here until Tuesday. Sucks and dies
to a lot of popular stuff. I still had some fun and had some good stuff, right?
So did good you?
Stuff there.
We're going to ban somebody. Somebody was probably saying something stupid.
672, yes, I can start over from the beginning. What you need to do is press play on this stream at the beginning because you can actually rewind. Although the stream is going to go private in about 10 minutes. When I go offline,
so you can't.
Then I'm gonna
so you actually can.
So just
so so you can't. You actually can. So you actually cannot rewind the stream. If you want, you can actually go to Raw Fill and see all of this horrific content. But you actually factually cannot rewind the stream.
Verify what's coming up here.
Oh,
so
God.
The podcast from this morning. Okay. And then I received a $10 tip.
There you go. Got part past that.
Jack Yak. I like a lot of things about you. But I think I like about you the most is consistent and reliability. How consistent and reliable you are.
Consistent
I know that
reliable.
You're streaming every day
all
ahead of time.
Reliable
I know that
Phil.
You're there without fail. I can't name a single other YouTuber I follow that I could say that about. And I don't know how you do it, but it's appreciated. You don't know how I do it. It's very simple because I treat this like a job. There's really? So many other content creators out there.
DSP treats it like a job. For the last like 10 plus years, he's been showing up in pajamas. He wakes up late, he stalls for 2 hours, gets to the thing that everybody wants to see, which is the video games, and then yells at you if you give him a suggestion on how to improve his business.
And
he treats it like a job, though.
There who are, let's
okay,
be honest,
sure.
younger than me.
Yeah.
They don't take it seriously. To them, they're goofing off, especially yeah. when they're much more popular than uh-huh. someone like me. They think that they could just fuck around and skip a stream or just pull, you know, jerk their fans around, and they're so popular, nobody cares, right?
Oh, yeah. Is that how it works?
This is work. Even though I absolutely have fun with it, it's my...
Dude, there was like a stream just a week ago where he wasn't having fun. He was literally yelling at us about how many RPGs we were playing. Bro, come on. I treat this serious. I treat this like a job. He gave us an ultimatum. You had to pay up. You literally had to tip your staff. If you didn't, we were going out of business. It was a sandwich shop moment.
Job. I treat it just like any other job, right? If I start becoming unreliable.
Yeah, unreliable,
with
Phil.
You guys aren't going to come back.
Dude, he promised so much shit we were going to do for this birthday. He was bragging about how... Well, we have to talk about it early because we got to talk about all the cool things we're going to play. All these multiplayer games, all these amazing games. We're going to make a real marathon out of this. We didn't even have a cake. We had a fucking brownie. We didn't even know the food we were going to order until the day of. We didn't even do the thing that we praised Derek was going to do. We didn't even, dude, we didn't do a tier maker and we didn't do a fucking quiz. We didn't do anything. Oh, I am so glad I did not restream all of this.
Right? You're going to get tired of that.
I would have been mad. I would have been mad at Dingus.
One thing and then
Dingus would have been in the doghouse.
Why would anyone even show up to a
stream if
they can't
rely? Dingus wouldn't be able to show up anymore. Dingus would have been like Snoopy.
On someone to show up.
He would have been having to fight the Red Baron to come back in.
What happens is if you lose
that
kind of reliability with your audience, now you got to pull stunts and shit to try to get people back, which I don't want to do, right? I want people to come here for the consistency.
I told them this is not a good idea. I'm glad I didn't do it.
Come to DSP Gaming or DSP
I saw the
React
two segments
DSP
I wanted. The eating and
the
eating.
Content that they like as
and
per
the after
schedule.
Eating.
And it's
like
not going to falter. Now, every once in a while, something does go wrong. Right?
Yeah, he didn't even drink. He literally didn't even drink. What was the point of even saying we were going to have liquor and booze? We didn't have anything. Oh, we didn't drink. He's about as sober as I am right now, and I didn't drink.
Every once in a while.
Oh,
but
God.
There's not much I can do about that. It's just extenuating circumstances, right? Yesterday,
I'm glad
I lost an hour
into
of
a drinking
Elden
stream.
Ring because
if I did, I would have been
inspectors
fucking blitzed.
And testers for my alarm coming here, and they were half an hour
shot
late.
For every shot he didn't
control.
Take.
For the most part,
every
I do
$50.
My best. You know, it hurts me when I can't deliver.
Olds
for example,
titty.
Do you remember Halloween?
Yeah.
I had COVID. And when I had COVID,
wait,
I couldn't
what?
Be here for Halloween, and the whole week I was out. I wasn't.
He literally didn't know if he had COVID. He actually factually did not test for COVID. And he is claiming he had COVID. No, and the thing is, he actually could have had COVID, but he refused to test for it. He refused. And we're pretending. We're literally pretending right now. What are we doing? Oh my God.
Excuse me. And we missed the whole Halloween marathon.
We
and a lot of people
it.
Love that Halloween marathon. To them,
yeah,
it's a tradition
do
I've done
afterward.
Every year for like a decade.
Couldn't do
and
it
to
afterward.
Not have it actually upset people.
He literally chose not to do it after the fact. This is. This
and I know
is
why. It upset me too.
Absolute bullshit.
So that's why I work hard to try to be here for you guys and live up to the promises that I made.
You remember when he made the promise
you're
about how he
right
wasn't going to run ads if it wasn't going to give him a lot of money? He was only going to make like $5 a fucking stream off of ads. He wasn't going to subject people to it. But now he like fucking bombards people with ads. How much, you know what? I dare somebody to tell me who didn't have like ad block on. How many ads this guy must have had today? He had to have had this on heavy. There's no way he didn't. It's okay. The stream's
Brian,
done.
I promise. I commit
I
to you.
Care.
I'm gonna be doing that stuff. That's what I'm here for, man. You know.
Let's get past the grandstanding. This is a grandstanding segment. Oh shit!
People
look at
appreciate
that. Miss that.
I mean. So, it's. I'm glad to know. I'm.
Prayer hands.
Glad.
Prayer hands. I'm glad to know, you love me, and my content. Rage. Prayer hands.
Glad to know that people appreciate the work
yeah.
that goes into it because it's a lot of work.
All right, we're done with the grandstanding.
All right, guys, last chance.
All right, last chance. Rock. Chat. Blah blah blah. Picks out some nonsense.
Final thoughts of the night, everyone. You guys were an awesome audience today. What I really appreciate about today was literally next to no drama. The trolls tried and failed to do shit, and it didn't work.
Yo, next to no drama.
It went down without a hitch. Great.
Man,
like I said,
thank
so much
God
better than
Derek
last year, where
fucking
last year we were ingrained in so much fucking drama at the time, and it kind of soured everything around that time of year. And this year, complete opposite attitude, right? Everything, a nice casual day. Wear a nice comfy shirt, hanging
casual
out with
day.
You guys. It was really awesome.
New shirt.
Tomorrow we're back to reacting.
Great.
It's React Day tomorrow.
We reacted
nonsense
tomorrow.
It's going to be the podcast here on this.
We literally reacted to shit today.
This channel, and then it's going to be DSP versus the internet on DSP React, and then it's going to be DSP Throwback. And on that night stream on DSP Throwback, it's the premiere of The Walking Dead Telltale
Whoa.
Series Season 1, Episode 1.
Walking Dead.
Episode.
No way.
We're going to attempt to get through it the entire time, all right, the one stream. It's great. People have always wanted to see me react to this. You know, during the entire Heavy Rain playthrough, people were asking for it. So I certainly hope you guys will come back.
People asked for Heavy Rain because they thought they were going to see the N-word moment, which wasn't in the original playthrough for Heavy Rain. He thought it was, and that's why he tried to, like, warn everybody ahead of time, but it wasn't. And the only reason why people want to see him look at The Walking Dead is because he has a weird moment where he looks at what's her face? I can't remember. It's the girl in the series and how she has to like stitch her arm up. I think it's like in chapter three. I think it's like chapter three. No, it's not the slave trade. Yeah, Clementine. He has a weird moment with Clementine where he's like, he does a weird thing with it. It's fucking wild.
For that, it's going to be a very nice night stream. Fun. Gameplay this returns on Monday with the conclusion of Alone in the Dark.
Okay,
and by the way, if
this.
You didn't see the podcast, I'm here my normal schedule this week. Segments. I'm actually here Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday.
So I can enjoy this
Thursday
on my
is my day off this
week.
Originally, it was
going to
be Wednesday, but my wife's work schedule
streams.
Changed. So now we're stuck.
And have it
we had to shift the schedule around
reference.
Again, just so you guys know.
For
I'll
all
be
the shit where he was like not in the chair. That's probably pretty good. It's worthwhile.
Thank you,
everybody.
I appreciate you. Jaden, we'll see you tomorrow. That's fine. Enjoy WrestleMania. Everyone else, please have a good night. Thank you all. I had a great day today with all of you.
Y'all,
and I'll see you all in the morning for the podcast,
okay? Okay.
All right, everyone. Peace out. Have a good night. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Hell yeah. We got the bye-bye. I love bye-bye segments. Bye-bye segments remind me that this guy is feigning to be human. He's like, like a skinwalker, if you will. Yeah, lean in manual bye-bye. Sorry, JC. Week has been fucking hectic. I had the thing installed, but I didn't get around to streaming it. I did get Neo. That was pretty good. I unboxed her and everything. We took off the plastic. I changed her head and her hands. And I'm gonna leave her in the box right now. I don't wanna take her out again. I'm thinking about it, but it's like, I don't have anywhere to place these figures. I got like Pac-Man sitting in front of my one screen. It's nuts. Saw the webcam. You're gonna stream? No, I'm not gonna stream crap like that. I'm not. I have been thinking about whether or not I wanted to send in my whatchamacallit to that guy out in wherever the fuck he is, out in the Midwest, I think. Thinking about it. It's only 200 and whatever the shipping is. Maybe. I don't know. I guess I want to get through the nonsense with this whole wedding thing coming up. The real question is, you sent my or yourselves? All right, well, that's good to hear. The real question is, if the service goes down, can we still use the multiplayer or what? No, I'm not getting married. It's somebody from the family. So I gotta be there. I gotta attend. I got my garb ready to go. I'm very spiffed out, if you will. I don't know. I'm ready to enjoy chilling and relaxing and having a cool event. And then maybe having a little mini vacation. I'll try and record, but I don't know. I'm kind of on the fence. Have fun at the wedding. Yeah, we'll appreciate it. Thank you. Okay, we're going to have anime night on the Discord. I've been looking forward to that all day. They have things that have been downloaded. I have reorganized all of my hard drives. Well, at least most of them anyway. We're 80% reorganized, all right? It works for what we need. Thank you for the hydration. I do appreciate it. I got to rehydrate the hydration. At some point. We're getting the fuck out of here. Who are we raiding? Somebody, you know what? I might just raid Devin. Who else is on? Who else am I following that's currently live? Bob Ross? No. Bro team. God damn it. Bunsenberry, what the fuck are you doing? Horror stream. Alf? We love Alf. Alf is great. Ayami's doing some nonsense. Oh, wait, look, Shroom Dukum's on. Oh my god. And Unfun. Oh shit. Wait, how long has he been doing this? Been doing this all day? I feel like he probably would have been doing this all day. Yeah, he's been going for 11 hours. Oh, this guy's insane. How long has Shroom been up? Nine and a half hours. One of my only oh, he's gone. Gonna be done soon too. What the fuck?
only one of my days.
Yeah, we're not doing that. We're sending you to Tevin's place. You can have fun over at Tevin's place. He's currently examining the Bimbop. Holy crap! I missed that? I cannot believe I missed that. Oh, are you kidding me? I want to see if I can get that. Yeah, you know what? I can't. Hold up. Oh, hold on. We need that. We need that face. I can't walk away without that face.
That my wife made. It's fine because you leave this year. No.
We can't go away with
this year. But instead a brownie with some peanut butter. Let's see.
I like how he's always eye fucking himself.
Okay. That's whack. Thanks for giving a membership, and it went to Toasty Ghost. Congrats, Toasty Ghost. Okay. Let's see.
Mmm. Very tasty. Mmm. Mmm. Very delicious. Crunchy. What? Okay, crunchy.
Like this before. The brownie part tastes amazing. It's nice. It's moist, chocolatey. But definitely the peanut butter frosting needs more time to cool. But it will. It's in the fridge right now. Just a matter of time, I guess. If you think about it, we ate around 4:30-ish.
She loves so really peanut butter anyway, with everything, huh?
But it tastes great. The peanut butter flavor is good. I like the crunchiness of nuts on top. And it's fudgy. Nice and chocolatey fudgy.
I can get so many good screens out of this.
It's my style of a cake with the crunchiness. Yeah, what's wrong with paper plates? Anyone?
Oh, the paper plates rant. Thing? I don't need to fucking hear the paper plates rant again. Such a nonsense rant. The reason why people make fun of him for the paper plates is because he never uses anything other than paper plates. That's why he gets made fun of. Even at Thanksgiving,
you're an idiot.
He's been shown to use paper plates.
Of all the things in life to be worrying about, you're worrying about paper plates.
He knows he gets fucking ridiculed for it. He gets roasted for it because, like, they're way too lazy to do their own dishes. And it's like an actual cost. A cost in the household to have paper plates to eat your meals. Wild. This is a green state, by the way. Oh man, is it? Yeah, you know what? Did he private it? Oh, he did private it, didn't he? He totally did. Dude, can we stop? Can we stop? I just want to be able to get the one segment that I want. I wish so much. I wish so much. I really do. I wish so much. Firefox didn't suck so
Felix
much.
Felix
made
like the reacting.
I did hate Firefox.
Yeah, I had two drinks today. I had a mojito and I had a Long Island iced tea. I had two drinks today.
Like, it feels like it's not as... No, it is as shit as here. What the fuck? Our connection's not even that bad. Oh, and I'm going to shut down those other streams. That's what we're going to do. We're shutting down those other streams. Just in case you're taking the bandwidth from
multiple
me.
People saying that in chat because you're idiots. You know, it's not like my wife didn't just completely make this from scratch in the kitchen, had to wash a ton of dishes because she did it.
Right? Yeah, it's not like my wife had to wash some dishes because she made me a fucking thing.
Right? And maybe I...
Who's VIP? Broken mailman. Oh my god. Hello, broken mailman. Welcome to the stream. Looks like you've achieved a VIP status. Big ups. Here's your VIP as contractually obligated. Get that gem and hopefully you don't get crushed.
I want to avoid having her have to actually like wash dishes because we don't have a working dishwasher. It's been broken for years. You know, do a nice thing. Just use a paper plate and throw it out. You don't have to wash it. Oh no, but you know, paper plates on your birthday, right? That's a big deal. You're an idiot. Of all the things in life,
you're a complete moron.
You're
a numpty.
About paper plates.
You're a numpty. You're a complete buffoon.
I mean, no brain, yeah. Right?
He says, "No, it's illicit. Stop." Don't! Aw, oh, you son of a bitch! I wanted that frame! Aw, oh, fuck. Well, we'll have to worry about that later. I got a couple of good ones. I got what I needed. I got what I can work with. Yeah, the other things that I can work with as well. People in his chat that are fake as fuck. Bickerns Vargans, Pinto Beans, Eternal. Oh, that was a clear screen of Eternal. Shug, Can Do Boss. This guy is weird. It's Hutch. He's a very weird individual. He's kind of for real and fake at the same time. Gabriel the Bless, Lilica, Hybrid, Monty's Bish, Girl Wearing Purple, Big Papa Phil, Baby Man Gaming 123, Elden Ring is an RPG, Meatball Man, this person named Sweets? I made a video about DSP with Whaletail Gin. It was, I don't know, something. Blastoise, Souls, Reese's Pieces. I don't know how they got away with that fucking profile picture, but there you go. Irradiated Rat. Some guy whose channel doesn't exist, but he's hanging around there. Plumber Fixes Leaks. Maximum Turbo. Haley. Opium. Sonic. This weird guy, I don't know who the fuck this was. It was like token something. John Smith, Hank Williams, Egg, Cream de Coco, Justice Lawman. Okay, those are all of them. So there you go. Look at that. That was just on one stream, by the way. One stream, all I did was just click on their profiles to see who was talking in his chat. All of those people, fake as fuck. Fake. They're all fake. All the people, like 80% of his chatters, were all fake motherfuckers. You people that are in there fucking LARPing and shit, you're literally the reason why he's still around. You like to make him pretend that he actually has an audience that talks about him. Nobody actually cares. It's just a bunch of fake people. Fake people created in the last year. Some of them that were created back during the Mario RPG shit. Some of them created within the last 2 months. Out of 357, 340 are not there. Yeah, basically. I mean, I don't expect all of those people to be talking, but it's like, dude, come on. You know those people are not real, man. They're just not real. But it is what it is. Okay, we're getting you the fuck out of here. I'm going to start up Anime Night. So if you're on the Discord, you can join me there on the Discord. And if you're not in the Discord, I'm sorry. You're just not in the Discord. What, we're sending you over to Tevin's place. Why? Well, it's partly because other people are like basically been streaming for 12 hours and Tevin's gonna be there at least for a little bit longer. That's gonna be something good.
You guys like the game so far?
God damn it.
But it was extra gross when he did it.
Look at Tevin's having fun over there. That's okay. Have some fun over there. Have some fun for me, because I can't. I'm going to be hosting the nonsense. Okay, quick shout outs for those people who were being extra positive. You didn't have to, but you chose to. So I have to recognize you. I'll recognize you very, very quickly. Big up Sir Axeman for the follow. Thank you, Manolo Azul, with a 22-month resub. Almighty Tenon with a 22-month resub. I stay with Aang like Stitch stays with Lilo, Ediebot Party. Red Animator with a 20-month Prime. Peaky Hachima Snorts. I gotta find that out. If there was like a clip, I gotta find it out. Sweet Bean with an 8-month resub. Happy birthday, Anne. Why to Kirby happy? It wasn't my birthday, but thank you. Happy birthday to you too. 20-month resub from Apache Goatee. And new sub from Too Quick Too. Pickups. I appreciate it, dude. I don't know. I'll try and play some games tomorrow or something. Maybe. Possibly. There's no promises. And if I did promise, I would be a liar because, you know, I always break promises and shit. Next weekend, I'm not here. I probably will not be able to stream, but I'll bring my phone with me. And if I stream, it's going to be like one of those weird when I was at Vegas streams. Yeah, it'll be like that weird when I was at Vegas stream and I popped up randomly and I like did a stream for my hotel. That'll be the only promise. It's not a promise, but it could happen. We'll see. We'll check you guys later. Bye bye.